Yo, hey Twitch, what's up? A bunch of people's names. I'm too lazy to read today. What up, everybody? Though, happy Saturday. Hope you. Oh no, my headset on. Holy crap! Forgot. Whoopsie! I knew something felt weird. Happy Saturday. Here's my battle account zero. Oh god.
Hello, Regis.
Don't sign me up for that.
Legendary you don't currently have.
I think that's scary. I don't want to be in the game. I don't want people yelling at me. What will they do to the hero portrait? Catch up, thanks to the 25 months. Oh my god, a golden ledger you don't currently have, but you wish you did. Oh, I don't know. Nothing comes to mind. Let's think. Golden ledger that I don't have that I'd like to have. Let's see. We're going to kill some time anyway here to get started. None of these are jumping out at me. Aya would be pretty cool. Tyrantus look cool. I always thought Yisiel had really good artwork, but never gets used. Beautiful art though. Rexxar would be a cool golden. That'd be sick. All his dudes would be golden. That might be my pick. Deathstalker Rexxar. I got Don Honcho. Who's gonna use that? Like what? What good's Don Honcho, you know? Rexxar would be cool though. We are indeed continuing yesterday's duels run, that's right. Yep. Why does it show that I don't have... Oh, I have gold array that's got double O. I say, what the heck? I wonder how much money it'd take to get a full golden collection. Certainly more than I'm willing to... More than I'm willing to offer, but I'm just curious. I bet it would take a lot. Somebody's probably done the math on that, but not me. Yep, doing yesterday's duels run. As soon as people get rolling in, I don't want to start too early. At least $20. Yeah, I think that's right. Yeah, I think indeed it would be more than 20. Do you guys hate this? I hate how when you mouse over, it gets bigger. Boom, it gets bigger. It's visually distracting to me every time. I still think these look way better this expansion, though. They're so much more, like, three-dimensionally modeled. Looks cool. There, when he moves his head, like, that's actually legit. Hey, Katie Page. Wow. Ketchup just dropped a 250,000 dust bomb. How do I can never figure this out. I am actually dumb when this works on crafting. How do I craft? Oh, here we go. A 250,000 dust bomb in chat to make me craft a golden Rexxar. Wow, dude. It's so nice of you to ask what you think it should be is, or what I would want it to be, as opposed to making me use a meme like Duskfallen Aviano or something, you know. This is a great relief, dude. Wow, thank you, man. We're gonna have to play some wild with this eventually in the next few days if we want to get some use out of this. But sure, yeah, here, I'll give you what you want. The 250,000 dust Deathstalker Rexxar. What a highlight to start the stream, dude. That's awesome. This is a wild card. Are you sure? Yep.
The eternal hunt has begun.
It's actually beautiful, too. Wow. Golden hero portrait to come, or hero power to come with it. We got some value. We'll get golden minions when we create them. We got some value. I guess those aren't, or no, it probably is animated, right? Yeah, they always use the same artwork, don't they? Yeah, that's sweet, dude. Wow, looks good. That actually looks good. Wow, thank you, Ketchup, dude. That was exciting, dude. Very fun way to start the stream. Wow, Pickle surprised at their bachelor party. Amazing. Congratulations and have fun. Thanks for stopping by. probably some jokes and stuff there, but I'll leave him be. Yeah, Zombies Golden, Hero Power Golden. That's a high value Golden card for sure. Golden Hero cards look good too. I don't know, something about the framing like really fits these. They look so elegant and stuff. Yeah, see you next week. Wow, Pickle, congrats, good luck. All that stuff. Be safe, indeed. Have fun. Everything. All the well wishes for you. Okay. I guess we've waited long enough. People aren't here in the first 8 minutes. That's on them. Well, I guess it's really been like 5 minutes since I hit started, but you know. So, to recap, since you've been gone, this is our... Well, it started out as a Boar Paladin. We have Elwyn Boar shenanigans with a bunch of like copy effects and stuff. With Gift of Luminance, which we have gotten off, if you missed it. But it really transformed more into a Discs of Legend Paladin. And we've been doing shenanigans like copying Cariel Rome's to great success and having legendary synergies off of Royal Greatsword with all these big Ragnarosies and Lich Kingies and Tyrianies, all these things. We've also got Ancient Reflections in here for our boar, if we can hit it. And we're at 9 wins somehow, 9-1 so far. I really thought this was a garbage deck when we built it yesterday. I thought all the boar stuff would really hurt us. Turns out, it's actually moderately competitive. I don't really still think this feels like a 12-win deck. I didn't think our last deck felt like a 12-win deck either that went 12, though. Not our last game, but our last 12-win deck. So maybe, I don't know.
I enjoy raiding.
It seems like Sword of the Fallen in particular has carried our early game. We've hit this a lot in the early game, so maybe mulliganing for Sword is really good. So you play it on one with Crystal Gem, right? Hey, Swagwar, dude, thanks for the 47-person raid. Wow. Appreciate it. I'm playing with wild-ish cards. Is that worth something to you and your fans? Some of these cards are wild. All right, let's look for more proactive stuff to do. You guys have game audio, by the way, right? Sometimes it doesn't work. Oh, okay. Oh, this is so bad. We draw this anyway. Oh, this is twice in a row. I think we've hit this in the mulligan. I remember right, the last game before we quit yesterday was the same story.
My faith is my shield.
Really unfortunate. It just kills a draw, basically. Because I was going to get that anyway. That's really, really bad. All cards. Well, fair enough. Sure. Indeed, all cards are in wild. I guess I should specify... wild specific, huh? So this still only hits boar and wax elemental, huh? I still haven't filled in the gaps on this. Boy. Do we take a sound of elves here? What did my opponent have? Inspiring and discs. That's really scary. Why is my opponent's stuff not showing up in my HS replay? I need to update this sucker? Restart it maybe? Let's see. I always rely on that to check their treasures. Thank God I looked. Wow, Swagwar, dude. That's amazing, man. Thanks for the kindness. All right, we'll just intern. Really terrible start. I mean, our deck is better later, so hopefully that's enough. But this is a really, really terrible start. Also, where is my deck tracker? I restarted it. Coin. Oh, wow. They're rocking discounts, doubles. They are so far ahead. They are like 6 miles ahead at this point. I'm going to have to rip a call to arms. Oh, hold up. Let me get Deck Tracker up again. Thought I did, but apparently not. I'm going to have to rip call to arms just to get something in play. It's going to be awful. Why is Deck Tracker not working, guys? My deck tracker's dead. Start, bro. Here it comes. Now it's working. Okay, sweet. Sorry, that's my window sounds, guys. Sorry. Sorry. I know you guys hate that. Yeah, we'll just tempo a henchman, I guess. What else am I supposed to do? This hand has just been a nightmare. Hopefully they don't have a ton of late game legendaries, right? If they do, we're not going to be able to swing this and like overwhelm them, right? We'll just end up falling behind because they'll have just as powerful late game plays as we do. And I have a terrible opener, of course. Theirs isn't like crazy strong. Wicker Flames aren't the end of the world, but they're not. Sure not bad either. Better hit here. This can trade a little too easily. So boars are in the pool for whatever that's worth. Not much. Quality is so Avery bad,
my
dude.
Daughter is in the hospital,
so
and your
bad.
Stream VODs help pass the time. Get my mind off it. Thanks for all you do.
So bad. Oh, 3 Aatrops. Hey, Stavo, thanks for the Prime sub. And Heretic, oh my gosh, 1,000 bits is absolutely incredible. I'm sorry to hear that news. I certainly wish you the best, and thank you for showing your support. I'm happy to provide any kind of solace or service. My wife actually works at Children's Hospital as a nurse. So I've heard many stories and seen the other side of that equation a fair bit. Oh, okay. Hit face, maybe? I don't even know. Diamond rank's beautiful, though. So thank you much, Heretic, and well wishes, of course. Good vibes indeed, as David S. Pumpkin puts it, in David S. Pumpkin's season. So I need one more turn here, but weapon was like the clutchest draw. I mean, this is like keeping me in the game, right? Weapon is so powerful. Maybe the only way to flip this back in my favor. Pretty good answer to Rag, but not like super high powered, right? We still. Oh, baby. Man, I wish I could have got Rag there, but I wouldn't have the mana anyway, I guess. Do I like take a Lich King if I hit it here, or maybe a 4 Dragon to get a crazy buff? Okay, I didn't hit either of those, so that is not a relevant consideration. Rag? Can I get a Rag here? No. This idiot is really ruining my day. I'm gonna hold on this for higher value, I think. 4 Dragon's pretty good. Lich King's not bad if we hit one of our Lich Kings. It's not great, you know, you just kind of get a full hand of stuff that's not that exciting. But it's not terrible. Okay, those are probably going to get like Divine Shield and Rush, right? Oh, Wind Fury, interesting. Wind Fury Rush, oh wow, okay. Going to try to squeeze some face damage through, I guess. It is actually sort of annoying. Oh, whoa, not even attacking with this one. Huh. Okay. I kind of get it. Shutting down my weapon attack here, but still could have maybe went face with that last guy. All right, we got 4 Dragon, Tarim, Rome, and Lich King off this weapon. None of those are that good. I'm probably just going to dump double Lich King, right? Could go double Tyrion to extract some Divine Shield value. And I will need the weapon, because this is my last weapon charge. Press the attack. Let's just see what we get and decide from there, right? Ariel. Man, we didn't hit the best roll. I mean, even our Ragnaros wasn't that good, right? Do I need the Lich King cards now or not? Nah, let's wait. Let's just do the Tyrion thing. Like I said, I think the weapon... getting the weapon equipped has some value. Let's see if he has big Aatrops or not. Like, if his legendary quality is as high as mine. Because I certainly have some high-quality legendaries in hand. And then I'm setting up... Oh, Reflections on Rag. Let's go. Okay, he's got 2, which is awfully good as well. Surely you don't trade these first, huh? Are those both going to go face? No way, dude. Those both go face. Why do you send both those face, I wonder? That really actually makes my reflections a lot worse. Because I can't kill off my minions now. I mean, do I still just take four Ragnaros, though? It's really not as good, is it? Man, I was really hoping to be able to trade in some minions. Jeez, kind of a weirdly heads-up play, and the fact that they both went face is scary. Don't test. I guess we just take four rags. I mean, I think it's too fancy otherwise. I'll gain some life here, too, to mitigate that face risk a little bit. And I can play it on my Yogg to, to maybe protect my board a little bit as well, right? Surely these die, don't they?
Thanks to Mrs. Kilbin.
We hope they die. I mean, if not, I deal 32 damage to face, which is certainly a decent consolation prize. They don't always die, but maybe one dying would have been okay anyway, too, right? I mean, I can't complain about this. I just kind of wish I had like six rags and a weapon, you know? We probably would have had a lethal setup, particularly with the equality. Could have like traded in Kariel and my weapon to buy some extra face damage. None may steal our secrets. Well, that's not too good. It's a lot of mana, honestly, too. Oh, that doesn't matter to me at all. That is totally irrelevant. Cool. Not that this matters, but might as well for fun. See what we get. Rag? Oh, we haven't even had a rag die. Never mind. No rags. It's the Sidian again. I'm really relieved we won this game. I felt like we got off to the worst start. But weapon was a good draw to help me kind of recover a bit. And certainly Reflections rag was rather powerful. So 10 wins. Dude, we just keep rolling with this. I think I take Greedy Pickaxe here. We have a lot of ramp value because we have so many high value, high powerful plays. Princess isn't bad though. Princess copies herself. And I do have some death rattles, right? I have Tyrion. I have Elwyn Boar, but that doesn't really help. That's not actually a very good death rattle to copy. The death rattle isn't what's counted. The boars themselves are what's counted. So yeah, actually, she's not very good. Also, I think I have enough threats, right? It's more about getting to my threats that is important. So I still like Pickaxe better. No, we're fine. Okay, 10 wins. Wow, this run has... I mean, I thought this was a two-win deck, maybe. Like a one or two-win deck. Oh, I missed some cheers. Oh my god. B. Jeffrey with a prime sub and Heretic again with 1,000 bits says, thanks to Mrs. Kilbin. Pediatric nurses are very special people. Cheers. Oh, I'll tell her you said that. I'll let her know your appreciation. She likes it. It's hard work sometimes, of course, but she likes hanging out with the kiddos for sure. As much hanging out as can happen anyway. Mm-hmm. Princess is bad with sword? Well, I mean, it'd be fine. I mean, double sword is not great, right? Like, you don't need two swords. I guess if you can stagger their deaths, it's good, but that seems pretty unlikely. Yeah, no, I think we made the right choice. Huh, I don't actually think we keep Boar, right? I think we're too far gone from Boar being a good thing anymore. Oh, we definitely keep Kariel. If we keep Kariel, do we keep Potion? We don't have coin, so I'm not playing Kariel off of our Crystal Gems. I don't know. I could play Boar on one and then Hero Power on two. It's a floating mana, I guess. This kind of replaces itself if I played Boar on turn two with three mana. But I don't really need Boar. I don't know, man. I don't really want to be a Boar deck, right, at this stage. I think I have to do better. Kariel's amazing. Looming Presence and Rust Rot are totally fine. They're tempo plays. Well, I mean, this is tempo play, and this is a refill play, which is nice. I don't love this, but we're going to get our 2-drop guy as well, right? Henchman. Thankfully, we didn't draw him this time. We've mulliganed into him twice now. Yeah, I do agree with the general logic of don't settle, find better cards. At this stage in a duels run, you kind of have to play for maximization, right? You can't really play just to settle. I think I'm actually going to do this. We can play Presence on 3. It's okay. Kariel's going to catch us up on 4. Bolvar's a pretty powerful play in the mid game too. So let's just see if we can find cooler cards. I guess if they play a scary legendary weapon, I'll be kind of sad, but not that sad. By the way, we have duplicate treasures. I don't think his legendaries will be better than mine on average. He might have Rattle Gores, which are pretty scary, but those are very, very late. I might just be able to overwhelm before then if his hand doesn't keep up. Although his hero is very good at keeping up with stuff. So we'll see. It's probably just going to come down to who gets like the first big crazy legendary pair to stick. That person will probably win. That is not a big legendary pair. This is such a bad card again. We keep getting wrecked on the call to arms. I mean, thankfully at the moment I have all three of the minions still in the pool. So that's good. This is actually really handy. I gotta kill a turn again because of the stupid crystal gem, but I might be able to play Greedy over Kariel, right? Just to really push towards this Bolvar. Get Bolvar down. That's going to start buffing my board like crazy. Or my hand like crazy. Gets me closer to Lich King as well. I think we will go Greedy. Seems like this game's going to have a timeline that's long enough to let Greedy be important, right? Especially since I do have the 6-mana payoff for it. So next turn's probably just Henchman unless I find a better 3-mana play. Goody two shields or something would be nuts. Doubt we'd use Lightbringer's Hammer, but maybe. Maybe just one hit on it's worth it. Ooh, crazy. Tarim's not worth. Yeah, this is not good by any means, but it's fine. It's a filler. It's not great in my hero power either, of course. It's the one downside we've had to this card over and over again, but if I'm really behind, I may have to play Kariel. If not, I'd really like to get away with a Greedy Pickaxe. That's always Runthac, we found out. When we played the other side of this, that's Runthac like 90% of the time. I don't know if it really is. It's probably not quite 90%, but it sure felt like 90% of the time. Double trading the bigger minion, huh? Okay, makes sense, I guess. Get some hero power value. I think we'll just Greedy face. Certainly not the scary board I was worried about for the Kariel, so... Set up for Bolvar. We're gonna be rolling. Hearthstone.
I called multiverse in HS long time ago.
Next, Commander Shepard. Commander Shepard coming to Hearthstone? That would be a very strange crossover. Whoa. The remote controlled golem. That's crazy. This is fine. We'll just hit face again, right? That sets us up for Lich King next turn. Just really good. We actually are kind of light on threats, weirdly. This is a game where we've hit ramp, and now we don't quite have the threats to pay it off. I mean, Bolvar, the cool thing about Bolvars is, right, they make threats. Any of my three minions become insane because of these Bolvars, right? Which, it's Warrior has universal removal, so we probably don't want to overcommit, like Brawls and stuff are scary. Kariel could lead to even more buffs if these Bolvars stick, which is something we'll have to consider as well. Poison seems good. Call to Arms terrible. I mean, we may play it eventually if we have spare mana just to tutor bad draws out of the deck. That has some value, of course, but... Okay, looks like one Bolvar here will die. Which means Kariel's still going to be pretty nuts because the other Bolvar will probably live, it looks like. Unless they find something here that's really good. Oh, that's not bad. They can kill both now. Yeah. Oh, they decide not to, though. Oh, no, they can't. No, they can't because of Divine Shield. Never mind. Okay, cool. So, the Kariel's huge. I get two of them. So she's going to create even more buffs off of this. I don't know how hard to go here. I definitely don't want to commit too much, right? I think I'm going to just carry L and, like, sword. Maybe, actually, this is a pretty good chance to call to arms. Because... No, I guess it's not, because I don't want to play into Brawl too hard, right? We'll just sword hero power. Oh, I could have got another Bolvar off this hero power. Oh, this is a mistake. Oh, shoot. Don't be Bolvar. Don't punish me. Oh, crap. I just missed Tintin and buffs. Shh. Shh. Decided to make my play too late. Shh. I didn't want them to be too big, okay? I just wanted my opponent to have a chance. Ah, crap. I'm really sad. That was actually another Tintin and buffs, right? Yeah. This is insane to get back regardless, though. Kind of no matter what. Did we get an Omayak? I didn't even notice. Oh, we did. Wow. He has coin, though, still. Oh, crap. We're at turn six, and this bro has coin. That's kind of wild. Wonder if he'll test it. No, he doesn't. Oh, Bolvar. Oh, good God. I really don't want to overcommit here. I think I just attack and hero power and play a greatsword and save the greatsword for the reload next turn. I really don't want to overcommit, right? Like, I have a 23-23 Lich King. I think I'm going to save it. He still has coins, so the Omayag is actually not that protected. I'm assuming we'll be able to play the Lich King next turn in a more safe fashion, right? Press the attack. It could be even bigger, right? I messed up, remember? I actually screwed up. Oh my god, did I actually have lethal almost? This weapon was an additional 5. I guess I wouldn't have had a lot of mana for Sound the Bell, so not quite, but... It was weirdly close to lethal. Oh my god, I might actually just win too easily. Shoot, I really want to get some value out of this Lich King. I was expecting more functional board clears from this deck. Wait, does he not get double Zilliax because he magneticed? I just saw that. I just realized that. Yeah, he only gets one because he magnetized. He might have been better off taking the two distinct Zilliaxes, right? Oh no, this poor guy can't even clear my 5-1 now with that. Oh jeez. He needs like a brawl. I feel bad. Don't concede. Let me play this, dude. Let me play this. Come on, be a pal. Hit my shield. Oh, Ranker's not bad. Hit this. Oh man. Sadly, I have lethal. No! Ruined! I never get to use the big guys. We just win too easily. Okay, man, again, we just did it. I don't know, man. This deck's wild. No, not good enough. This deck's crazy, dude. I really still don't get it. Everybody's a little slower. So we've just had time to... Bad time to hit our crazy legendaries. That was some nutty ramp. I got too greedy. You mean by not being greedy? I actually was the opposite of greedy. I played it very safe and conservatively to play around removal. You guys wanted me to be greedy by dumping another 20 minion on board for no reason. I was trying to play for the win. Anyone have the initial deck code? I really, I wouldn't use it. I don't think it was very good. We had like a bunch of garbage boar stuff. It actually wasn't, it wasn't a good core deck. We just kind of got bailed out. Oh man, reflections early, boar early. I got Reflections and Boar. Is this really how I'm gonna win the run, dude? Is this real? I can also coin Reflections on turn two. So if the boar sticks on one, I could actually get seven boars on turn two. Because of Crystal Gem. Of course, they have to die is one problem, but... I think I'm going to play it on one, because I can always use hero power to get it back if he, like, kills it or if it fails, right? So... why not? Like, yes, that would take more mana later because of the reflections, but... oh my god, what if he hit Ancient Reflections into my boar? Like, does he kill the boar here? He may not kill it. He may decide, like, oh, I don't want to kill it. Even if he does, like I said, I can bring it back. It would take, like, you know... oh my god, he left it up. Oh my god, he left it up, dude. Why not play Righteous Protector? Oh, I could have, I guess. Yeah, I don't know, actually. That's a good point. I didn't want to put it in the pool is why, but maybe it would have just been better to guarantee this. Okay. It may have just been better to guarantee it. My thought was like, oh, don't put it in the minion pool because I want to be able to hero power guaranteed. But if I thought 100% boar was going to stay alive, I guess there's risks of like Pinflinger and stuff like that. Pinflinger's not in bucket, so it's banned. But anything that went over the top would have ruined my game plan. But maybe worth considering more. I think just taking the short thing's fine though. Oh my god, he got the boar. Okay. Turn three. No big deal. Oh shoot, I forgot that was going to get buffed. Oh shoot, I forgot that was gonna get buffed. Actually kind of annoyed. Okay. Turn three, Sword of the Fallen. Okay. I got or turn two, yeah, excuse me, yeah, turn two, Sword of the Fallen. Yeah, it's actually three mana, but it's turn two. Unbelievable, dude. Oh my god, I actually can't believe this happened. I cannot believe this happened. Turn two, Sword of the Fallen. That's the craziest thing I've ever done. And it's on the 12 win game as well. Unbelievable.
Well done. My thanks. Press the attack.
This is without a doubt the greatest. The greatest thing I've ever done in Hearthstone. What an insane way to end the run. Just absolutely perfect. Yeah, it was turn three, guys. That's right. Yeah, it was turn three. Because I had to attack with the boars. Yeah, you guys are... I was right when I said it's turn three. Yeah, you guys convinced me I was wrong, but I was right. I had to attack with the boars for the sword. I mean, I got it done on turn two. But not exactly, right? I had to attack. Only turn three. Get out of here, you fools. That was unbelievable. I cannot believe that actually worked. crazy, dude. What an insane highlight. Oh my god. And we go again. How did I get seven boars? Ancient Reflections plus Elwyn Boar in the mulligan with Crystal Gem. Have I traded Staking the Claim Hunter? I guess not, since I don't know what that means. I don't know what Staking the Claim is. You gotta use not names. Whenever you play a discover card, all friendly minions gain +1/+1. No, I have not done that. Why does that interest you and Hunter specifically? I'm curious. What happened with yesterday's Paladin run? Rewind about 2 minutes and you'll see. Go into the VOD and go back about 2 minutes and you'll see what happened. You missed quite possibly the coolest thing I've ever done in duels. Okay, let's decide what to do next. You have a lot of discover cards plus Unleash the Hounds. Okay, Unleash the Hounds is cool. That makes sense. I don't really know if I want to try for that quite yet. There was something I wanted to do in Rogue, I think. No, maybe not. Well, I kind of want to try Legendary Loot again. Oh, I did want to do Quest Rogue. I never did do Quest Rogue in duels. I feel like there's some decent Battlecry synergies for Quest Rogue. Is there anything else that's really good for Quest Rogue in duels? Any other good passes? Battlecry discount, which is harder nowadays. Battle Totem, oh, actually, is pretty good with Quest. Double Scabs is kind of cool. I feel like there's some neat Quest Rogue stuff we could do. And of course, you never know, sometimes. Oh, which Quest? I mean New Quest, sorry, SI7 Quest. Oh, it is true that you can't quite get duplicate SI7 stuff, can you, though? So it's harder to get the quest done, isn't it? You could play around that with Shadow Steps and stuff, but it would still be challenging. Let's think about that for a second. Do you think it gives you enough SI7 buckets? I don't know. We can try. I don't need a good long duels run. We obviously just finished an insane one, so. We don't have to make miracles here.
Welcome, boys.
Has anybody ever played around with this and like Wind Fury minions and like crazy buffs and stuff? Like giving a minion stealth and then just like buffing the crap out of a Wind Fury minion seems kind of insane on this hero power. I wish it wasn't 2 mana though. Might be hard to get that off. I don't know. Let's take a look. I bet we can build. Like, we could use this to bounce SI7 cards, for instance. We could use this to get extra SI7 cards. I think I like this one a little better. It's kind of got some cool plays. So, SI7. Are there any additional wild SI7s? No. Man, that's sad. So, I mean, I think we technically have enough, right? Particularly with Ace in the Hole and stuff. We should probably try to run, like, a Shadow Step. Any other good bounce effects that are available that are just really good for us? I also want to just run some damage, of course, because this weapon can actually pump quite a bit of damage out. So we might just be able to kill our opponents on occasion with burst damage. So, playing for damage outs feels pretty good. Like a mix of SI7 and damage. This looks okay. I don't know if I need secret passage, actually. Oh, tin was a good idea for a bounce. Yeah, tin was good. Thank you. I like this. Good mix of damage. Good mix of SI7 stuff. Should I put in that swindle for a little bit of card draw, maybe? Make sure we have the draw we need. Couple bounces for SI7 stuff. I like this. Fine curve, I think. Weapons, good damage output. We can just win the first couple games on damage. And then build out the deck from there, basically. I don't think we can do field contact because we don't have cheap enough Battlecry or combos. I mean, maybe we do. I don't know. Duels, though, you know, it's like three mana and then setting up for like another 4 or 5 mana. I think we'd have to have like exclusively one drops to make that good. I don't see how we're going to do that. It is true. Garrett gets worse. Harote. Over the course of a run. It's really good early, though. I sort of still want to keep it just because it's so good early. Because it's so much damage in the early run. Like the first couple games, when decks are small, I'm very likely to hit this. And it's just like might win me a game or two by itself. It's still 2 damage in a base. It's not like nothing. Just a cheap kind of playable spell. Thinking about maybe finishing on a Vanessa, though, too. Because Vanessa can get cool treasures and stuff. Right? I don't know what I'd cut. I like having the flexibility of Wand Thief. I think Swindle's probably important. Swindle can help me, like, dig for treasures and stuff, for instance. So maybe we don't need that. Okay. Let's roll. I think it's really, really important to get through the first few games of duels. I think my duels win rates and like run qualities have dramatically increased over the last month or whatever, right? I'm winning way more on average. We've had so many like 8, 9, 12 win runs lately. And I think a big part of that is just getting over the first 3 game hump, right? Like if you can get over the first game hump, you can use deck building skills and stuff to help you late the run. Like I seem to be okay at getting to a good final build. It's the fact that I lose a couple games early that was always holding us back. And now that we're not losing as many games early, I think we're in a better spot. So in other words, building the deck really, really fast early has seemingly helped our win rate. That said, you know, bad decks still lose, so hopefully this isn't too bad of a deck. Hopefully this deck's okay. Priest in particular is really scary. I don't know if we'll be able to win the Priest race, particularly with these cards, just because they're so slow. This helped, though. This is a good curve. Play a minion. Play a rare Priest minion. This is actually going to be a decent play on 4. It's not going to be great, of course, but it'll be okay. You guys ever seen anybody? I feel like I've never actually seen anybody play Quest Rogue in duels. And now I'm thinking about it. This quest, anyway. I know we tried the other quest once. I don't think I've really seen this. Maybe that's a sign. Maybe that's a warning sign, right? Why isn't anybody playing this, Regis? There might be a reason for that, bro. We just go for damage output here, right? It's time to race. This is worse. I could use this to hit a minion if there were one, but it only hits minions. If this hit face when it died on death rattle, oh my god, it would be so busted. It's already pretty good. It would be so busted, though. Okay. Always void, dude. It's always void, isn't it? I just hate playing against Shadowward Void. Also, that binding heal is brutal. Okay, so weapon will kill 2 of these. Also bounce this guy. It's not bad. I don't have lethal, do I? I have 6 and 4 is 10. and hey, two no, is 12. Today I would have lethal. They didn't heal. Hunter deck, and the that's kind of wild. Choice of Bucket had live to win. Bucket with three more Elwyn. Oh my god! So there is that good so boar fun. Bucket. We never hit it. Oh my god. Trudis, you got to go back and watch. You got to watch the duels run we just finished. I'll just leave it at that.
Hey,
you got to watch the duels run we just finished. That's all I'll say. Man, like we're so close to lethal, but I think I actually still need to deal with these minions a little bit. We're probably at a breakpoint where I could stay alive if I kill a lot of these and maybe just win next turn, right? So it kind of sucks, but it's where we are. I wonder if I should leave alive one or not. Because this does really change my math quite a bit. Let's see what gizmo I get. I might... Yeah, this is not a great gizmo. Like, right now, right, I don't have a lethal setup. I have 8 in hand. I mean, there's a lot of things I can draw that would hit lethals, right? But hopefully 10's enough to buy me at least a turn to find out, though. The moment we don't even have a turn to find out.
I started it yesterday. Did something even more crazy happen today? More crazy than
I would argue something more. I don't know if it's more crazy, but it was just very perfect. let's say that it was like the stars aligned. I don't know if it was quite as dramatic, but maybe the stars aligned. Okay, they played a dude apparently because I had a random weird little DC. Koala Fishy with 40 months, man. Thank you, Koala. What happens if you play Maestro in duels? I actually have no idea. That's a great question.
There was a farmer who had a dog, and Reggie was his name.
Koala Fishy, I am not reading all that, but thank you for the insane, kind 40 month sub. All the same. Yeah, so we don't have lethal, so we just gotta play this straight up.
Oh, what's the rush?
Probably dead here, right? 8's not a lot. I mean, they didn't kill me last turn, though, so maybe they don't have it yet. I don't know. 8 is really not enough, though. A fair bit of damage chilling in the deck. They're just digging or maybe using this to kill me, one of the two. Maybe both. Oh, that's lethal for sure. Oh, whoa. Oh, my God. Oh, so close, dude. They almost killed themselves. Hearthstone game completed. This is not a Hearthstone game. This is a duels game. As we all know, Hearthstone is the main menu button. This is in the modes. Oh, she's banned in duels. Oh, okay. That's why we've never seen it. All right. There you go. It doesn't work because she's banned. That must imply they didn't, like, have, you know, sort of the solution or whatever. So, oh, my God. I forgot to open my pack on that last run. Oh, my God, guys. You should have yelled at me. Shoot. I forgot to open my pack for that run. Let's open our pack. Wow! We got 12 wins and we get this insane pack out of it. Oh my god, this is like the dream. The perfect duels run. It's like the perfect duels run. Bolner! I even got a Bolner! Wow, this duels run gave me a Bolner. That's not gonna be the name of the video, but it sure could be. That could be the name.
Welcome. Boys, make some room by the hearth, won't ya?
Little late. Man, like Sticky Fingers is so cool, but it's not good for our idiot gizmos cuz they always cost one anyway. Rachel with 50 months. Wow. Works with Ace. It does work with Ace. It's also good with these bounce effects and stuff, I think, right? I think it works with bounce effects. I'm not actually sure now that I say that. So it's probably worth it more than the other ones because Fire Shaper's not that good. Caltrips I don't love. So I just wish it worked with Scabs itself. I think it's the lesser of all the evils. Okay, here's some stuff to bounce SI7. That's a secret package we don't need. This is a sticky fingers bucket, sort of, but not really. I think I just take this. I don't love headcrack, but whatever.
Traditional Hearthstone. There is Hearthstone Battlegrounds, Hearthstone Mercenaries, Hearthstone Arena, Hearthstone Duels, Hearthstone
Tavern. Really not confusing at all.
Hearthstone Solo Adventures.
Oh, true. Scabs will be cheaper. Scabs himself being cheaper is actually pretty nice. Yeah, that's a good point. Get the scabs down quicker, but the problem is, right, if we don't hit more SI7 cards, we're never going to get scabs. It's like we're just never going to get it. Sergeant Sadani, dude, thanks to the Prime sub. Welcome, welcome. Rachel, 50 months is totally insane. Good to see you, Rachel, by the way. How's everything going? Give us the updates. We want to hear every detail of your life. Give us your story. Lillian versus Lillian.
To ruin my espionage.
No. Okay.
Say
seven's probably all right. No combo at the moment, but we'll find something. Shadow Step's good. Okay, we've got that other hero power. We'll have to operate off weapon early, I'd say. I'd love to see like an SI7 extortion on turn two to combo hero power, get some damage through. Whoa, the floor is lava. Oh my god, I actually hit the extortion. That's kind of wild. Called it, man. This is 5 damage face, which I think I take. It kind of leaves me without a great turn 3 option because I just have to tempo an SI7, but maybe that's okay. It's sort of awkward, isn't it, now? Do I clear the minion or go face? I think I clear the minion still. It did play around using SI7 extortion on the minion rather well, given the floor is lava. I like the notion that the floor is made of lava, but standing on it only deals 1 damage to you. Somehow it's not a lethal blow. It doesn't kill you, it just deals... So basically the story is if you stand on lava, it's just sort of painful. It doesn't really kill you, it just tickles a little. It's like getting a thorn in your shoe. Oh my god, what a great update from Rachel. Graduated, got my dream job, and busy as heck. That sounds great. Grats. I'm doing great. Doing good. Hearthstone has high fire resistance. Yeah, that's what it is. It's all that fire res we've been farming for Molten Core. Okay, I guess this to set up the combo on the weapon's fine. I don't think I bothered to shadow step. I suspect we can do better. Let's see what our gizmo is. It may be better than weapon. I don't know. I kind of want to leave this in hand to better activate combos and stuff. I think I'll just use weapon. It's not a bad shadow step target. Oh, no, it's pretty bad. Never mind. I don't want to do the same thing twice. It doesn't really stack that effect. I'd rather shadow step like a operative or a... I don't know, whatever. Not an operative, an informant. These names are very confusing. If somebody gave me a quiz on all the SI7 names, I think I would get Skulker and Agent, and the Operative, Infiltrator, Informant would all be a mystery to me. I think I'd actually get Assassin. That guy looks pretty distinct. The other ones would just be nonsense. I wouldn't know them at all. What do we want them to not have? I guess I don't want them to have Lotheb or Field Contact. Wriggling Horror, I'm probably going to clear their board, so it's less valuable, perhaps. I'm definitely going to clear their board. Lights out. My blade stays sharp. Is this a good Shadow Step SI? I can re-weapon, which is okay. I don't know. I think I'm just going to do this. I think Shadow Step may still have more powerful plays incoming. Just spin this mana, basically. I mean, even on informant, it's not bad, right? Next turn, I can informant, shadow step informant. I can finish the next step of quest and get a really big informant. Smile. Although, honestly, not that big. I think it's moderately sized, but at least it would fuel itself to some extent. Okay, I can hit that with weapon, no problem. Brain freeze button? That's not bad if that's all that happens. Actually, this is probably a better shadow step target if it lives for damage output, right? I think I'd rather hit really hard. Maybe I'll find some damage here. Bleed. Okay, that's damage. Yeah. Nice. You're pretty likely to hit your bleeds early in this run. That's what I was talking about. Is this lethal? No, I only have 4 additional, but I might be able to get something cool off the thing here, but I don't think there's any lethals, right? Nothing deals direct damage. Maybe I ought to still do this in that case. To like, oh, but there is this big poison on board. Okay, well, I can shadow step this, kill that, and then play the informant. That's a really good turn, actually. We don't need to go for the lethal blow here. See what I get. Probably still playing informant, though, because it's ginormous. So we kill the poison to protect this. Oh, this isn't bad, but I think the big thing is just still worth more. Although, I don't know, is it? I mean, this is just straight up 5 damage in the... My opponent is running taunts, though. No, I think this is better, because they have taunts. I mean, I guess they had 1 taunt. That doesn't really imply more taunts. I don't know, maybe this isn't better. We saw 1 taunt guy. I don't know if that really means they're a taunt deck. I think they just put in good battle. Oh, sort of a taunt. Oh, it is a taunt because of the floor is lava. I'm a genius. I'm an actual genius. I'm a god. Broom is really good there too. Is head crack lethal? No, it's 1 off. Shoot, man. Confidential. But it kind of sets up a lethal, right? Just fine. So, good stealth minion on board. Lethal over the top set up with head crack. So, 16 health, so I feel pretty safe. What an insane minion to get with the floor is lava. Burning Blade Acolyte's nuts. Like, that's really good. Kind of crazy. Hey, Savon Donules, dude. Thanks for the 2-month sub, man. That's really nice. They were trying to go for Staking the Claim, but they whiffed. Oh, is that right? We think they go went for a Discover deck. Okay. Is Staking the Claim really that good? I mean, it only buffs minions on board, right? Is that powerful? Does it just buff, like, does it buff the Discover playing minion itself, perhaps? Does that make it feel better? I don't know. I don't guess I get it really, but... Whatever. I think I might take Astral Portal, guys. Clockwork Assistant. I mean, we have some spells. It's not bad. Blood Moon. I mean, I don't know. I don't think we're gonna get anything for Blood Moon. I kind of like Astral because it can steal the game. I know there's low rolls too, right? But that's okay. We can tank a low roll. I think the occasional high roll is worth it. Like a game stealing high roll. Because basically we don't have to play this if we're in a spot where it's not important. I mean, what am I going to do with Blood Moon? I do have some minions and some stealth minions, so it's not terrible. I just, there's going to be so many instances where this is dead. I like cards to be independently proactive. Right, I want cards that can do things on their own. And I feel like Astral Portal is the card that does that. Blood Moon is very rarely going to hit more than, what, 2 minions? It's like 2 in buff and 2 healing. I don't know. Every time I take Astral Portal, I end up regretting it. But in theory, I still think it's right. Uh, I actually still think Astral Portal's the right choice in theory. I'm going to take it because it's fun. I don't care. I would say Blood Moon's probably the safest bet if you're playing this draft yourself and you want to play the goodest card, because goodest is a real word that you should use. Take Blood Moon, but I'm going to take Astral Portal. I take this damage. I don't have a lot of card draw to support it right now. It's my big concern for the damage. But it's like crazy with Ace in the Hole. It's just like insane if I get Ace in the Hole and like Sinister Strikes and stuff. Is there any card draw here? Foxy's not card draw. That's not card draw. That's not card draw. This is like not really card draw either. I'm going to need a card draw bucket soon though, man. Or treasure. I'm going to need like bag of loot. I'm going to need bag of loot soon. We'll see. I'm going to really regret this Blood Moon thing, aren't I? Because I'm going to roll like Lorewalker Cho the first time I use Astral Portal. I sure hope I hit like a Tyrion or something to make this worth it. Just to be like, I told you so. You guys don't know anything about Hearthstone. What did I tell you? Tyrion is the way to go. Actually, I'm going to need Ragnaros Light Lord against Priest. So let's, oh my god, it's time. It's here it is. It's time. Oh, Staff of Pain. I'm super dead. At least it was fun. At least we enjoyed it. Yeah, I need Rag Light Lord to heal up all this priest damage. I guess we're racing, right? I have a pretty damage-heavy hand. It's gonna be really hard to win, but they also hurt themselves on occasion, right? Because of Staff of Pain, so if they don't keep breakpoints in mind, we might just be able to win a race. Kind of need a play here, though. I need Ace in the Hole. Is that worth it for one Sinister Strike? I actually think it is. I think it's worth it for one Sinister Strike. Because basically, when am I going to have the mana to play this later? And what am I going to do now, right? I'm going to eviscerate for two and re-weapon maybe? Use it on Portal instead, but that's 7 mana commitment. That's what I mean. Like, well, 6 mana commitment, I guess, because it'll be discounted. I don't know, guys. I'm not sure that's worth. I also don't know if this eviscerates right just to get a re-weapon. I think it is, because it's basically going to pay for itself next turn, because I get to attack next turn with this newly equipped weapon as I Astral Portal. So basically the Eviscerate does the same amount of damage, right? And I have a weapon equipped for increased flexibility of my turns. So I think it's worth. There is a world where I could go Ace in the Hole into a one mana Eviscerate as well. They healed, yikes. All right, let's go. Rag Light Lord. Rag Light Lord. Oh. Not bad, actually. Not bad. It is an 8-8. It does limit my opponent's ability to do stuff. Don't have Shadowward Void, please. They always do. So I don't know why I said that. Obviously, they're going to have it. Oh, Vampiric Fangs. Oh, God. Oh, I'm dead. Well. Great. That was exciting. My blade stays sharp. GG. They just got a mega heal 8. It's It's great. Is there anything off Astral Portal here that can save me, right? Lothab that I can Shadow Step? I don't have mana for that. Oh, I do have mana for that, actually. I have 6 mana. That would be pretty sweet. A Shadow Stepped Lothab. Problem is now, right, like, I've ignored this minion in favor of a race to engage in, and now they healed for 8, so it's like the race clock just went crazy. I can't really win anymore. GG, I was the Nuzstorm. what miracle do I need here? That is not the miracle, I gotta say, bro. First Flame can help me clear the board. Well, not really. Kind of sucks, I don't know. Is fierce, isn't it? This isn't worth, right? The toxins aren't as good as this stuff. First Flame again? For real, man? If these only got discounted, right, with Sticky Fingers, I keep getting offered really already cheap stuff, so it doesn't get discounted, you know? It's kind of annoying. Well, I'm obviously not winning. I mean, they only need 4 damage. That's literally any 2 shadow spells, so GG. It's another good heal slash damage dealer. Man, I mean, I think I actually got a decent legendary off that Astral Portal. 67% of the time, that's a good roll, a game-winning sort of roll. I just happen to have the... I actually almost think I would have preferred they had Void Battle Totem's what we were winning, right? Oh, Khadgar's is kind of intriguing. We have gotten to the point where we have a lot of spells. Our battle cry is going off twice. Let's think about that. It's like Skulker's pretty good. Tin Woo's actually not good. Man. Infiltrator's okay. Informant's really good. Assassin's actually not good. Is this actually Khadgar's? Am I now like a spell deck? Because a lot... I mean, I guess Battle Totem's really good for Scabs, and it's good for... Well, really only Scabs and one of the... No, not even really one of the Gizmos, right? But then Khadgar's also works on the Gizmos. Makes them 0 mana in many cases. I think it's actually Scrying Orb. What a weird idea. I didn't expect to go this route, but now we can build more towards spells as well. Oh my god, I love this, actually. Because I need card draw, and Potion of Illusion being cheap makes it a very powerful play. This is indeed about the sneaky tricks. Okay. I still don't really know how we're winning games, but... But we'll figure it out.
And your hand can be too full for double scabs anyway.
True, yeah. Double scabs is 10 cards, so it's hard to actually set that up. 3 mana Astral Portal has to be good, guys. I don't care what you say. 3 mana Astral Portal OP. Do I even keep Quest at this stage? I just have such a low density of SI7 cards. I wonder if I even keep Quest. Maybe so, just because even the first gizmo is pretty good. Yeah. I don't know. It's really debatable. It's sort of sad to lose a mulligan spot forever. Oh, man. If I get an SI7 card, actually, this is good. Oh, my God, I need Infiltrator. Flame Waves and Sticky Fingers. I love this. What are we going to do? Oh, my God, I got Infiltrator. This could be a counter spell, which would be sort of sad, but weirdly not that sad. Or Oh My Yogg as well. The opponent might get really excited about doing that, but ultimately, I don't think I'd be that distraught. Sadly, we did proc the secret, and we're probably going to proc all of them by the time the infiltrator matters. But maybe it's a maze. They could have more secrets, right? Let's see. They didn't do anything with my rogue quest. What a crying shame, I tell ya. Yeah, I'll go ahead and re-weapon. Just keep pushing damage here. Portal on 3 is great. I need to hit, I don't know, Grom? What do I even want to hit? I don't know. Doesn't really matter, whatever. Okay. 3 mana 5/5? Sure, that's what Mookla costs. I got a Mookla without giving them bananas. What do you know? Just fine. Not exactly treasure worthy, I suppose, but that's okay. Jayfish says, Regis, recently found your channel. Just want to say, I love your duels content. Oh, thanks, man. Yeah, I too wish duels wasn't so restrictive on collections, man. I'm sorry you gotta struggle through the duels restrictions and stuff. I really think duels is an awesome game mode lately. I've enjoyed it a ton. I feel like duels, we still try like weird experimental stuff, but we can still win in it, which is exactly what I wanted on Hearthstone. Like, we just had that crazy Elwyn Boar Paladin, and it won 12 games. So, spoiler alert. Like, that's what I want to see out of the game, right? Here we go. Beautiful. Eat that Paladin Seeker. What is it? Avenge. Well, that wasn't really gonna... That wasn't really gonna do much, I suspect. Probably gonna re-weapon next turn, so let's do this. Probably want to extortion this Phoenix and drop an informant just to get a gizmo. The informant's sadly not big at all. I kind of need like ace in the hole shenanigans this game to win, I think. I need like, you know, a turn where I take a Sinister Strike Eviscerate and then next turn I ace in the hole. So I need to like find a Cold Light Oracle and then Shadow Step it so that I have a ton of choices so that I can build towards that game winning state, right? One Thief might be better than Weapon here. Let's see what we get off this as well. Giving the Stealth with plus 2 attack would be pretty sweet. Oh. Okay. So what's the rub? I actually think I go Weapon now. I didn't know you had it in you. Instead of Wand Thief. Because we're like setting up quite a bit of damage now. This is 6 plus 7 is 13. I don't think I'll have any lethals off the top, but maybe in 2 turns I could. You have to read this. Voracious Reader, that's very weak. What on earth is this turn? I didn't know you had it in you. Wow, that was a weak turn. Really? Confidential. Do I shadow step this? It's expensive, but it gets me a gizmo. Yeah, I guess so. Gizmos are good. It's also just gonna get bigger, which is nice. So what's the rub? Sort of bigger. I mean, lower attack, but higher health anyway. Okay, we like this guy, but let's see if we can find some crazy damage or something here first. Ooh, Fireland Portal next turn. Not a lethal. Oh, it is because it's 6 mana. Okay. That's actually better for next turn with Wicked Stab. It may still not quite be a lethal setup, but it's probably closer. Sphere of Sapience is a pretty bad draw at this stage, right? That likely wouldn't change their fate much. So this is now 10. No, 9 plus 2 is 11. So I need 2 damage here to stick, which, you know, is really not that likely. I kind of played into a combustion here, too. Shoot. I don't think that's likely to see, but maybe. Uh-oh. Well, cold positioning didn't matter. I need 2 damage. Oh, Firelands Portal is even cheaper because of Sticky Fingers. I forgot that. Sticky Fingers and Khadgars. Oh, this is great. I have a lot of top deck lethals here. They attack face as well, so that's one extra damage. Also a good card for me. Wow. Is Headcrack? No, Headcrack's not lethal usually, unless I can get like a spell damage here maybe. No, this is 2, 3, 6, 7. Yeah, I'm one off. Shoot, I kind of need to like kill this mana worm now. Yeah, I'll just Headcrack here to get it back for next turn to have more damage. I don't have it, right? 3 and 4 is only 7. If I had one more mana, we'd have it. But I can keep the Voracious Reader here to draw a bunch, so that's fine. I think we'll be alive. I think we'll be fine. We still have a pretty big board. They don't have a ton of... Oh my god, Ace in the Hole is nuts. Okay, that's a good card to see. Yeah. That'll do. I mean, honestly, Wicked Stab Hero Power will do, or Wicked Stab Headcrack, whatever, but Ace in the Hole's pretty sweet. Why is that not lethal? Because 1 plus 2 is 3, plus 4 is 7, and my opponent had 8 health. Not sure what you're seeing, maybe? I don't think I'm missing anything, maybe? If you got an alternate plan there, let me know. Curious to hear it indeed. Yeah, maybe you're thinking I had more mana than I did. That could be what you're thinking about. Wicked Stab plus weapon was the remaining 6 health. Yeah, I didn't have mana for Wicked Stab. So yes, that would have been awesome, but I do have a mana limitation, unfortunately. And I attacked a minion, so yes, I could have put them down to 4, but again, I didn't have mana. I had to play either Wicked Stab or Headcrack. I couldn't play both. Zero mana remaining at the end of turn. Yeah, I think I like Bag. Bag is really cheap. We kind of need card draw. Helps me hit SI7 stuff. Book of the Dead, I mean, I love it. Don't get me wrong, it's great, but we're spell-based. I don't have a ton of minions dying, and my opponent doesn't have minions dying. This is a really expensive dead card, so I think I like Bag. Our deck is actually pretty well-suited to Bag. Oh my god, sure. Cheap, awesome damage and card draw is exactly what we want in our spell deck, yeah. Yeah, Fioris is not great for us. Book is not great for us. Yeah, I think Bag was a really... Actually, I think Bag was a great treasure. Not even just, like, an acceptable treasure, but maybe a great one. Oh, I think I keep Imposter if I have double Swindle. That's really good. I'm still pretty hesitant about Imposter because I think... We don't have such a high consistency of SI7, but most of our minions are SI7. I have double Swindle, so I'll get at least 2 minions. Also, I can play this on turn 1, right? I can play Imposter for 0 and Swindle for 1. So I actually get to reload this, like, almost immediately. Which is sweet. Is this Heroic? Yeah, I only play Heroic now. I don't ever play Casuals anymore. I mean, we've frankly been winning so much that I'm, like, actually... I mean, you know, I don't know. We do goof around sometimes, so I don't want to pretend that we always win. But we've been getting enough really high win runs that it feels like we're like pseudo infinite of sorts in duels, I guess. In other words, when I'm getting the good runs, we're getting like 250, 300 gold or something. I feel like my gold total is climbing despite playing Heroic Duels. It shrunk for a little bit because I conceded like 5 runs after that patch hit to get Hero Power Mage. Like, because I couldn't find Mage, just kept conceding and conceding. Like, retiring at 1 or 0 wins, but... Other than that, we've been, rocking pretty well. Can't go Extortion here, but we'll save it for a minion, maybe. actually just go hero power? Since I know I have the turn 3 play, it's not going to be hard to combo this later with like Sinister Strike and stuff. I think I just go hero power. Yeah. Let's just make sure we're squeezing in damage every time, because this is very much still a damage-centric deck. And every time I don't hero power, that's kind of a turn gone for 2 damage, right? They're even taking extra damage here off Warlock, so I guess they have both Flora's Lava and Caltrips. Just ping everything! That's sort of fun. I like that. I'm actually just going to play the Cold Light, I think. I don't really need to operative yet. We don't have... I could go for a thing, but this doesn't have a target. And actually, it never will, now that I say that. Oh, boy, that's good. Lead is nice. I don't know that it ever will have a target, because they have both Flora's Lava and Caltrips. I guess any second minion played on my side can be extortioned. I can extortion my own face as well, but... I don't really want to do that. No, this is the full Caltrips. This is not scattered Caltrips. No, literally every minion is always damaged. Shoot, I have to, if I wanted to extortion, I have to do my own phase. I guess summoned minions. There's ways to summon minions. That's how we do it. There are minions who can be summoned who weren't played. That's probably the angle, right? Okay, we are, I guess, in a race, dude. Let's freaking go. I mean, yeah, he wants to race. We're going to race. Let's go. Oh, these cards suck. What are these cards? Shoot. Guess I'll cycle the fan. Maybe I cycle the extortion since it's so bad. We're not going an SI route this game, right? So this isn't really worth more than hero power at the moment. But I do float a mana, but who cares? I actually almost want this to not be comboed so that I can make space for the bag. Don't think it's worth the mana here to lose 2 damage, but it's a thought. It's actually a thought. That does technically push the most damage as quickly as possible, right? This is a very tight race already. How much like raw damage do I have off bag that I can play like immediately, right? This rate's cost 1. There's a couple bleeds in there. I mean, bag is drawing half my deck, so there's a pretty decent chance I draw a couple of Eviscerates. So I can like open with Wicked Stab. Oh my god, he is just going, dude. Oh my god. I'm dead. 4. Shadow Step's also a pretty cheap way to draw a ton of cards. 6, so I need 8 damage. Shadow Step's a cheaper way to draw 2, but bag draws more, right? But I can only play 1 mana of stuff off the bag. So that doesn't really solve my problem. But this gives them 2 cards, which could also find them lethal, right? This is only drawing 4, but this game's gonna end in 2 turns anyway, right? So what difference does it make? I need to try to end now. Right? In that logic, should I maybe play for the Cold Light? It's only 2 cards, though. And I think it's this. Bleed number 1. Did I hit an Eviscerate or anything? No. What a terrible... Oh, I did hit 1 Evis, but it's still 2 damage off. Yeah, I don't think this matters. I mean, I'm probably dead. He only needs 7. It's not hard to do 7 in a pretty full hand. But I'm set up for next turn now. We have lethal set up for next turn just fine. Headcrack Evis is 6, so it's just whether or not he finds it or not, right? That looks like a lethal to me, dude. Jeez, man. He went so fast here. We actually had a really fast hand, too. I think we just got too many SI7 cards. Look at this, right? I needed to hit, like, 2 Evis off that. Or another bleed would have been fine, too. Jeez. This feels like it was a cool opportunity, this run. It just didn't go, right? Just didn't quite deliver. Kind of want to try it again, almost. Mask was lethal? How much mana do you guys have for Mask? I feel like you guys just forgot that mana's a thing. This is like the second game in a row where people want me to spend like 18 mana per turn. We played bag with 1 mana remaining. I maybe 2, I don't know. 2, I think, maybe. But regardless, Mask is a 5 mana card. Yeah, it cost 5, man, but I only had 1 mana left. It came off the Wand Thief and the bag.
Incantation and Rod are a thing. Nothing costs mana ever.
I'm losing it today. Chat has just got infinite mana, man. I played bag for 3, Wand Thief for 1. We had 1 mana remaining, and you want me to play a 5 mana mask? What am I supposed to do here? Don't give me a hard time. I can't play 5 mana masks with 1 mana. Yeah, I know standard you can just play every card every turn. It's infinite. It's not quite that in duels. I do actually want to try that again, but I don't think we're going to get like damage output again. I don't know, man. Ace in the hole was okay. It's like, am I gonna really build the SI7 line again? That kind of sucked. I think there's actually like an aggro rogue with just raw damage output that's probably better. I don't know if I really want to play that though. You know what I mean? Like that, I'm not sure that's actually fun. Like I'm sure we would win a lot, but is that enjoyable? Spell Rogue? I mean, there is Fire Shaper too, which is pretty crazy, which we didn't really get a chance to Fire Shaper. I bet there is a pretty cool Spell Rogue build. I guess Spell Rogue is a theme I could like kind of get behind, right? Because it's specifically about the spells. So like card draw, damage, set up for Fire Shaper pings, maybe a crazy oops all spells. Right. Could go poison. It's a little less over the top, but still not perhaps terrible. I don't really want to do poisons, though. Any good, like, spell burst or generators, like Wand Makers, maybe? I don't know if Wand Maker has that many good cards. Ivory seems pretty slow. Wand Maker, maybe Scorpid? I mean, it's a little slow, though, isn't it? What else makes kind of sense here in like a... What else makes sense? DJ Samp, I actually don't understand your question. What do you mean what happened? Hit me up. I actually talked to the Arcanian people the other day, so I can probably answer your question, but I don't know what you mean. I guess Wand Thieves. Discover Dwarf. You mean Wand Thief? I think she's a gnome, for the record, but yes, I agree. She's awesome. Cold Light's a neat idea, actually. I do want card draw for sure to find lethals. That's a pretty It's a pretty good option. Oh, DJ. Yeah, they go read their like Steam news post. They basically said like they got a deal or something. I don't know. You can go read it. Basically they're hard at work on some other thing. Sounded like maybe Switch or mobile or something. I don't know what exactly, but their last blog post. Oh, they literally just posted a week ago. I didn't even see this one. I don't know. There was some update though. I don't know what's public and what's not. So I don't want to say too much. I want to be respectful of that because I just talked to them the other day. Shadow Step, I think is okay. We don't have a ton of minions that I want to Shadow Step. I'm afraid it could get stuck in hand a little bit. I think I'm maybe keeping an eye out for Draw instead if I can. Maybe a Fan of Knives. Mimic Pod's kind of cool when we have all this burst damage, you know? Could draw some burst damage, but it's only a draw 2, right? That's not very good. It's also looking at Vanish. Oh, Thalnos is pretty good. Did somebody say Thalnos in chat? That's a good idea, maybe. See you, Grimgrod, dude. Yeah, have a good one, man. Thalnos is spell damage and draw, which is cool. Okay. Yeah, spell rogue. Let's do it. I don't know. Whatever. Lillian versus Holly. Ace in the hole. I'll put you out of your misery. Probably don't want that yet. Probably something I'm looking to just hit later. For now, I want Wandmakers. Yes, I'm probably going to SI their face on turn one because this is the 15 health game, right? This is a big chunk of damage. This is 20% of their health. Oh, no, this is the 20 health. I thought we had 15 health on game one. Is it 20? I've obviously not played enough duels. Regardless, this is the low health game. I thought we had 15 health for some reason. I guess not. Did I just make this up? I guess I made it up, guys. I don't know. Whatever. It's good enough. The point stands. The point remains that their health total is low. I've already taken them down to half on turn two almost, so. There you go. We'll play this on two with Reweapon. Thalnos bleed on three, probably. Or four, I mean. Yes, real Dennis plays. Holy Smite face on one. Is that what Dennis said? I can't even remember. It's been years. Hopefully I get another Sinister Strike here. I'd rather Reweapon, right? I want that mana. We're going fast. Secret Passage is good. It can hit me a lethal on 5, probably, right? Bleed will put them at 7. My weapon will put them at 5. They might have some armor gain. It's not impossible. Cargo guard, right? So that's something we might have to pivot towards. At the moment, actually, would be kind of a pain to kill. I would kind of hate to have to race it. Oh, that's not a pain, though. That's fine. Yeah, let's just go now. Because this cycles into a new card, we get some bleeds in the deck. So between bleeds and eviscerates, I bet we find lethal. I mean, we'll have to play the bleeds, but we'll have 4 mana after the secret passage. So that would be fine. I don't mind paying for those. But just race. Randomly saw the list of banned games on Twitch, and a lot of them are like WTF. Oh man, I was looking at all the Steam demos that are out right now, which actually I'm gonna stream demos tomorrow over on my YouTube channel alt thingy. There are some crazy games I didn't know existed. We're just hitting all the bleeds off the top, huh? Jeez. There are some games I didn't know existed. I'll put it that way. Some games I think I would go to jail for playing, and like at least YouTube jail for sure. Hey, there's Stake and Claim you guys have been talking about. It's really bad for me. I don't have any minions. Really, really bad. These are all really bad. I don't want any of these. I really wanted Fire Shaper. Specifically Fire Shaper. I guess I'll take Scattered Caltrips, because what on earth else am I going to use here? Staking a claim, I have one Discover card. Wand Thief. Two. Scorpid. Man, I hope that that didn't tell the game that I was going to have, like, Discover synergies. And it's like, oh yeah, we'll give you Staking a Claim for your Discover synergies. Oh no, yeah, Archimedes, that's exactly what I was looking at. Yeah, that's what I mean. I guess I must have them disabled because I saw them. I mean, maybe Caltrips keeps me alive a little bit. Right? Like it slows down my opponent sometimes, like killing little one drops or divine shields or something. Because what am I going to do buffing my minions? I don't have any minions, right? It's just not worth it. And same for Elixir. Like, what am I going to do? I don't have any minions that matter. I mean, I have 3 minions. 4, maybe. I mean, theoretically, I could get more. I mean, I'm definitely going to get more minions. Yeah, I actually think I like this better than Caltrips. Just because what is Caltrips going to do? This, at least, I'll get more minions in my draft. Yeah, I guess. I'm really sad. I really wanted Fire Shaper. This is more towards the game plan, but I don't hate the Swashburglars now that I have ever-changing Elixir, right? And these still potentially find me stuff to do. And, like, you know, they can find burst damage. They can find... All right, whatever. I don't know. I'm going to take these. It's more fun. Okay. This will be our last duels run of the day, so let's make it a fun one. After this, I think I'm actually going to go play some more Tavern Brawl. I wanted to do forcing my opponents to play control decks in Tavern Brawl. Like, I'm going to play, like, Odd Warrior or something in Tavern Brawl. And just force opponents to play Nazdormu and force them to play control decks. Is the boar run going to be up on YouTube? For sure. Yeah, 100%. Okay, health totals are still low. I think we'll keep the Sinister Strike. Actually, Sinister Strike Ace in the Hole is a pretty cool combo for later. I think I can fill my turns enough with this stuff and hero powers that I can save this. Maybe, like, you know, turn 4 or something, I go Sinister Strike and into Eviscerate or something, right? And then turn 5 or turn 6 maybe is better to save enough mana. I can play these together and have some wacky times. Oh, okay, fun. Oh, whoa! Nice! Already worth. Yes, absorb those pings, sir. Excellent development. I really want to, like, start comboing stuff, but I guess it's not time yet. I don't know what to get evolved. It doesn't really matter. Oh, that sucks. That's not it. Ugh, gross. That's way worse. Easy to ping off with Fire Shaper. Again, why is HS Replay not showing my opponent's stuff? What's going on, man? It's bugged out twice. Oh, I restarted Hearthstone. I wonder if that had to do with it. I don't know. Oh, first flame anyway. Okay. I might have opened with the first flame there. Maybe he wants the pings to go face, though. I don't know. Oh, wow. Prep Ace in the Hole is kind of crazy for later. I hate that I'm not getting weapons in. I think I'm going to coin a... Oh, my God. So, like, next turn I can go double Sinister Strike Garrote, right? And then on turn 5, I can go prep Ace in the Hole. That'll be 1 mana. And I can also double Sinister Strike Garrote. So I can actually use coined hero power now to set that up, right? Because 5 mana is enough with the prep. Discounts 2 now, right? Yeah. So 1, 2, 3, 5. Yeah, this is actually kind of a perfect line. And getting weapon hits in will just help me guarantee that I find enough damage, I guess. Hey, Flubble, dude! Their hero power is the secret draw? Yeah, no, I'm talking about Ping's a fire shaper. I would have hit this first to try to snipe the 4-1 with the fire shaper ping. I didn't mean pings off hero power. I mean these pings, right? Like maybe one of the ping to go face. I don't know. All right, we'll test counter spell on this. And this. And this. So I actually only have 8 damage next turn. It's actually not enough. Shoot. I think it's still right to do. Like we're bleed certainly put me in the conversation. But not actually a lethal setup just yet. Someday I'll be just like you. Oh crap! Does that need to die? Shoot. Also a secret again. Oh man, I might be counterspell now. If it's counterspell, I'm gonna lose all that upside. This like almost has to die though. It's so scary.
You get prep back.
Like so scary. Oh, true. I do get. You're right. Oh, I do get the prep back. You're right. I'm an idiot. That's why. Yeah, that's actually a perfect idea because I'm dumb. That's a great idea. I could have gotten extra petals as well. Oh my god, dude. And I'm still gonna hit counterspell here. So that's sad. Oh, it's not counterspell. But I still don't have a lethal setup. I only have 8. So do I need to kill this? I mean, I can still get those back and just kill the 3-2, right? I don't have to play them now. Oh boy. These are bad. Oh god, explosive runes too. Oh, I'm dead, dude. I'm dead. Oh, I'm gonna die. Oh god, I'm gonna die. Is this Oasis ally? No, okay, that's good. Duplicate, I don't think I mind too much. They gotta spend mana on those anyway, right? So, okay, so we're set up for lethal here, assuming that's not an ice barrier. Oh, but it's not. I already attacked, yeah, so that's good. Actually, maybe I shouldn't have attacked. Oh, I think that was wrong too. Oh, I think that was bad. I don't think I should have attacked. I didn't track the... There's no frost, I guess, so maybe we were okay. Either way, bad. Someday still bad. Someday hopefully I'm not dead. 12's a lot to do with 2 mana, even with the discounts, right? You just have to either cast a lot of spells or it has to be very specific damage, so I think we'll be okay. So this is 6-8 guaranteed, but that's 4-6 mana. Okay, so yeah, we're actually chill. Counterspell's a bit of a hiccup, though, if that's a counterspell. That would reduce my damage output. The bleeds cost 1, so I do need mana for the bleeds. If I hit a bleed, we're all good, I can guarantee. And I actually have a 1 in 3 chance to hit a bleed. Maybe I go... Okay, there. That means we're squared away, right? Now counterspell can't beat me. Oh, we're super squared away. Wasn't even counterspell anyway, okay. Cool. Yeah, I don't think I played this well at all, for the record. Yeah, the prep was a miss, like we could have prepped. I think I attacked into a barrier that I didn't, thank god I got bailed out, but I think I played that pretty bad. Hunter's Insight or just Worshipper? Worshipper gets transformed is the problem because of ever-changing elixir, so I think I'll take Hunter's Insight. It's pretty good with, like, Ace in the Hole, right? We can blow some pop-off turns, basically. Blow some pop-off turns. I don't know if that's English I want to be using. Doesn't sound right. This is a little bit too weapon-focused, maybe. I don't have a lot of weapon buffs for cutting class. These are decent. It's a little low value, so that's kind of scary, right? I might run out of gas. I do have a little more card draw and generation in this deck than before. Plunder is pretty good, like gives me reactivity and it transforms itself. Cultist actually kind of bad because it transforms itself. And I guess I could play it without combo and it's not bad. I don't hate here. This isn't bad. Headcrack some damage output. Coerce is good removal. It's a little expensive, maybe, for my deck. What do you guys like? Cheap or, like, slightly more value? I don't want too much value because I want to play fast. I do kind of like these minions, but I guess the coerce is really good, and the headcrack's inevitable damage too. Yeah, I guess. I don't know. They're both fine. I guess I'm worried about running out of gas on that right one, though. If we hit a bunch of, like, you know, not that impactful one drops, we were going to just be murdered. Huh. Oh. No. Oh. Oh. Blah, 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 blah. Yeah, bleed definitely carried. Yeah, I played that game so bad. Multiple things. I think we're wrong. It's all bleeding together a little bit, too. This is our third duels run of the day, so kind of bleeding together. Yeah, Agent's not bad with Evolve. That's true. Yep, that's another decent explanation there. Prep, I'm realizing, seems really powerful with our deck. I think I'll hold the prep. I will fight every teacher here if I have to. And I think we can do better otherwise, right? We want burglars. We want wand thieves are pretty good. I don't like secret passage this early. I like secret passage, just not this early. Staking a claim. Okay, they might have the same like staking a claim problem that I did, where it's just. I bet they have a lot of discovers, but I bet they don't have that many minions, right? It's maybe hard to get both. That's what it seems like to me anyway. Ooh, early wildfire. So I'm not the only person who does this, where I go for the cheap hero power. I got so much flack on that for YouTube. Everybody wanted me to go mana worms. But I'm not the only person who thinks that the cheap hero power is worth more than the mana worms, especially when you're hitting face all the time. Everybody kept saying, you gotta play your ice shards. I'm like, no, pretend the ice shards don't exist. This is like getting a Gin deck for free, basically, right? Like, you don't need the ice shards to make this relevant. The ice shards are merely the bonus. This turn sucks. Prep Evis Wand Thief, or maybe prep Wand Thief and see what we find. I guess I really don't want to use the prep like this, but I'm just short of any good turns. Yeah, these suck. I'll still Evis face here and just use the weapon. Save this combustion for something better later. Sucks that I have to. Well, I don't know. Maybe I don't hit the minion. Maybe I still just go face and presume I'm just going to combustion that next turn. I think that's actually better. Yeah. I think I just ignore that and go face. Shame we hit a 2-2 there instead of a 2-3. That's a big deal. Because they can just like combust two of these anyway, right? It's the same difference from a sort of I'm frozen standpoint, right? I'd be frozen at the same points anyway, and I'd still have a better setup. And then he'd have two more damage taken. I want to hit like Cold Light Oracle here. I guess I'd play like an SI7 or Scorpid. Headcrack is. Oh, bleed. I can't play it though. Welcome, boys. This isn't terrible. Gets me some damage, gets me a minion down. Headcrack comes back to hand, so it's like long-term damage, but I guess Scorpid's still the best bet. Get to find something of choice and... Oh, a headcrack anyway. There you go. Let's take the Shiv, right? It's good at killing the two ones. It draws me a card. Shiv's gotta be the pick. Whoa! I love the Baron. That's sick. I mean, it's just got high health, right? It might actually stick around to evolve again because of its high health total, which is insane. So Yeah, I guess his deck does have more minions because of the shards. I mean, they're still really hard to play in my experience, but that does give you a slightly more reliable minion push for the staking you claim. In fact, here it's pretty good. Yeah, it's a 4-3 now. That's not bad at all. I might be taking it back on the staking claim in the his deck. This is only gonna be good for ours, but. Hey, Corey Hutch with 13 months and Creepy Pow, dude. Thanks for the 4 months. Ace in the hole. Doesn't seem good now. Combustion's kind of wacky. Yeah, I think I'll just combustion this to get the freeze out of the way and just start hitting face. We're definitely in a bit of a race here that I don't feel super confident that I can win. But I'm getting a decently big minion. Hopefully, yeah, that's solid. Yeah. Yeah, okay. I'm alright with this. I think that'll be their last like really good minion push for a bit. Or if so, I might even just be able to ignore their minion push. So if I go ace in the hole here, I have, what did I play? Combustion and I had,
WTF, why is my MMR so high? I am playing against a GM.
Good luck. You have fun. Yeah, combustion, unfortunately, here is too expensive. Oh, no, it's not 3 mana. What am I saying? Perfect. We'll use it, actually, to clear the board. I was like, why am I frozen again, dude? I don't think I can leave myself at 6, right? Functionally, I think that's just a little too low. I think I have to trade here. It's a value trade to me because this heals up. Ooh. So we have 7 plus 5. 12 plus 2 is 14. Okay, that's not attacking. Gotta go a different route here. I mean, this is still 6, 7 plus 2 is 9. If I get some bleeds here, we could definitely hit a lethal. Like, I could Thalnos Shiv to try to find the bleeds, and then they even deal extra damage, right? Probably open the turn that way and then see what happens with the Wicked Stab. Assuming I'm alive. I may not be alive, of course, but... That could be an explosive runes. What did that come off of? The Wand Thief, yeah, so... Really no way to know. Oh, boy. Razor Petal's too much mana to be a lethal, right? We also have the risk here of counterspell and the risk of barrier. Okay, we didn't hit a bleed, unfortunately. So I only have 7 here. I wonder if that means I coerce a minion just to stay alive. I mean, I have to kill the minion, right? I don't have lethal. I'll be dead if I don't, because hero power is 2, and this is 2. So there's no question about killing the minion. So I guess coerce is the way to do it. So I retain damage in hand. Now I have... Okay, I do not have a dilemma about attacking face. I was going to say I have a dilemma attacking face. Oh, that sucks. I would rather have the Cairn. I'm sure they're going to have lethal, right? They have 2 Wand Thieves now. They only need 2 damage anyway. It's going to be very hard to stay alive here, but I mean, we got to try. That'll do it. Hey, Little Egg Monster. First time catching a stream. Well, thanks, man. Oh my god, will they die if I draw bleeds? How does this work? If I had had enough bleeds... Like, I didn't have enough, right? But how would it have worked? If they had been at, like, 2... And they played this and it drew bleeds? Does anybody know? What on earth is this garbage? You think it ties? Yeah, it makes sense. I don't want any of these, dude. These are the worst treasures we've gotten in forever. Band of Bees doesn't work because I took ever-changing elixir, right? It's just no good. All my cheap minions get evolved and then lose their poisonous. So that's not it. I don't even think it'd be that good anyway, for the record, but it would be almost impossible for me to stick a poisonous minion. Anytime I had two minions on board, sure, but that's so unlikely. Scepter of Summoning, obviously. Why? I think it's all together now, but this was like, I think, a middling tier one passive, and now it's a tier two passive. I don't think it's great. I mean, we have like Wandmakers and Oracles and Scorpids and stuff that are there that are cheaper, but it's not good. It's not good. Hey, Pyro, dude. Wow, thanks for the 36 months, man. So now battle cries make a little more sense for us. I also still like damage, I think. This is kind of neat. Questing's hard. I like the Garrote and the Shadow Strike a little better, but Cold Blood's tough to use. This, I think, despite having a battle cry, is just too minion focused still. Although we're better with minions now, so I don't know. Really not that good, though. I mean, these minions kind of suck. I needed this when I did quest. I'm getting, like, everything backwards. What do you guys like better, two or three? I think questing's a little hard for me to use because it gets evolved, so I'm thinking about three. Cold Blood I can use if I stick a minion, which we've been sticking minions, actually. A little bit, even against mage. But this deck seems just incredibly doomed. We built a spell-based deck. And got no spell synergies. I built an SI7 deck and got no SI7 synergies. This is what happens if you build really narrow lists and you don't get offered your treasures, right? But I still want to build narrow lists. It's more fun to build narrowly and try for the craziness than it is to just like build a hedge deck that's okay at everything, right? That's more boring, I think. Who wants to be boring? Lillian. Not me. I'm lots of fun. Are you trying to ruin my okay, good burglar early. But you're ruining mine. Cold Blood we want later. I actually don't mind putting the Garrote in early. We just don't have that many good plays early, so this is kind of one of our better tempo plays. I mean, I can dig for Scorpids and Wandmakers and stuff, but they're not great. Okay. Swindle actually, not good. Hard to use right now. Oh, Grom's arm guards and legendary loot. Wow, what a fun bucket. Cool. I mean, the Groms don't really go with the loot, but, you know, that don't hurt. It's a cool weapon synergy thematic anyway. Holy crap, I'm just dead. I'm actually just already dead. Great. Well, it was fun. Cool. I gotta say, man. Oh, they do go really well with Valinir. That's true. Yes. They generically don't go well together, but Valinir plus Grom's Arm Guards is actually sick. Yeah, they get to replay it cheaper. Good point. Even better. I played Legendary Loot, and I never got Valinir, and I got that idiot Minari, what is it, Skull of the Minari, literally 47 times. I'm so mad that when my opponents play Legendary Loot, they get Valinir. I just wanted you to know that I voted you and not win. Well, quite forward-looking, because I think you're right. I think you nailed it. So they can play Valinir soon-ish. Not yet, though. Oh, wait, they gotta get a minion to die first. They can't play it. Well, we don't know when they can play it. It's gotta get a minion killed, I guess. That's how that works, right? Kind of forgot, obviously. See what Swindle's got for us. Oh, Insight's kind of cool. Wow. His hand got wild. My plate stays sharp. Conceal doesn't really do what I needed to because the minion evolves out of stealth, right? Like, whatever. I mean, one of them, anyway. Oh, Wicker Claw's kind of cool. Man, I don't know, guys. We might actually be able to turn this. I've got quite a hand there. I've got a ton of damage, a little bit of healing. Like, I've still got the board. Wicker Claw's insane. Rep. Evis, oh my god, he's just going for it, dude. Play a minion so I can Devouring Plague. Pyro's the prophet. Pyro the prophet. So this is 3, 6, 8, 10... If I hit two bleeds, I think I have 14. Yeah, I don't think there's a lethal here. Probably gonna play this first then. Just to see what we find. Sinister Strikes ever give me a lethal out? I don't really see how.
I'm almost out of time. My blade stays sharp.
Well, that's close. Seems like he thinks I'm dead, right? He went so hard last turn, like I must be dead, right? Man, I keep rolling 3/4s. What's the deal? Paladin Silverhand Recruit 3/4s. That went from that other dude that's a 3/4 Silverhand Recruit card to this 3/4 Silverhand Recruit card. That is wild. Am I really dead? He top decked Sinister Strike for lethal. Oh my god. Oh, dude, come on. Float like a butterfly, sting like a bee. Ugh. I don't want these cards. This deck does not know what it wants to be. This is only 3 mana, so I'm going to take it. It's cheaper from all together now, right? I don't know. Whatever. If you can't tell, I'm a little over this run. If you can't tell, this run and I are not on good terms. I mean, what? This has got to be one of the worst, like, drafts we've ever had, as far as like treasure synergy, internal deck synergies. I don't know how we've won 2 games of this deck. It is a real mishmash here. I think we dig for good battle cries, right? Because that's like our only thing that's discounted and sort of powerful. So yeah, Blade's good. Blade's good. It's a good battle cry. Might be able to race again. We'll see. Oh, Emerald Goggles is too good, man. We're basically saying, oh, look, all your stuff is discounted by 2. I have a few things very occasionally discounted by 1. It's a good minion, I guess. It's nice. Elixir has definitely been good. You guys were right about the Elixir. I was pretty hesitant on Elixir, and I think it's been a good fit for us. I'm glad you guys suggested that. Don't hate Shadow Strike while it's able to hit face, but I think we just get this going, don't we? My place stays sharp. The minion buffs are unlikely to be relevant because of, evolves, but I just want the damage. This is actually pretty cool with it, too. I didn't even notice this. Did we draft this? Where is this from? Oh, no, this is from the Wandmaker. What is this card? Where did this come from, bro? I need Cold Blood. I think I'm just gonna go face. Right. Let's just paralytic this for one damage. Like, theoretically, I could play it on a future turn for two damage, but I just have the mana now. Maybe I could trade instead, I guess. Yeah, maybe trade's better in that case. Sure. That's better. Moonlight Oracle's fine. It's buffed, whatever. This was a good minion, right? Hit six damage off four. Oh, that could be fun. Kind of hope that lives. Paladin's not always good at reacting to stuff, so this might live. Oh, that's fine. For now. So that's cool. We are hitting very hard here.
My blade stays sharp.
Oh. Fancy. Okay. Oh, nice minion roll. Good defensive scary guy. That's cool. My opponent's at 12. I have a lot of damage available. A little bit of removal available too, actually, if they play like a big taunt. Them giving me cards and ramp off Mindpocalypse was very valuable. Kind of intrigued they played this so casually. I guess maybe they wanted to hit Humble Blessings ASAP, but man, they really put me ahead when they did. Okay, we can just kill that. That's GG, man. GG, dude. Cool. Wow, good win. Okay. I can actually attack. All right. I gotta say, ever-changing elixir altogether now carried there. Maybe they're better than I think. It wasn't, I mean, I don't know. It came together. That's all I'm gonna say. Holy Book's gotta be too expensive. I think it's Spyglass. Worshipper gets evolved, so it's kind of weak, theoretically. I mean, it's not terrible because the three attack's good once, but I think Spyglass gives me the most upside. Hey, Soifla, dude, thanks for the prime sub, by the way. That's nice. No, we don't need this. Academic Espionage. Man, is that in the pool? Because that'd be really fun to play in duels. I don't know if it's available, but I think that would be rather enjoyable. Oh my god, somebody voted and got a huge payout on the predictions, it sounds like. When are they gonna update duels? They teased that there's a major update coming sometime this expansion cycle. So I my guess is that it'll be with the mini set, which they said is coming after the Mercenaries patch. If it comes with the Mercenaries patch, that'll be a little bit sad. Because it'll be like crowding each other out, but that would not be unusual for duels. It usually, I mean, I guess the mini set would also crowd out duels a little bit, but I think if the mini set comes out with duels, I will probably play both like kind of simultaneously. In the past, I would have focused on the standard mini set, but I have a feeling now I'll sort of split the difference a little bit, which I guess I never would have thought of in the past saying that. Yeah, I really, really like prep. We have some very powerful cards to prep. Well, I say that, but do we? We really only have Ace in the hole now. Never mind. I'm going to play for minions and Battlecries. I take that back. We're actually, despite building ourselves as a spell deck, we have sort of turned into a better minion tempo deck. Strangely. Oh my. It was definitely not the plan. But these together are giving me some strong early turns that, he's annoying. Yeah. Sick. Ooh, early blade too. Boy, we are actually off to a great start here. Shroud of Concealment's actually really good for us. Our minions are better plays right now, so sure. I don't think I'll need Poisonous or Shadow Clone. Guess I want this to get hit so I have a stronger threat on board. Like a big 4-attack minion or something, right? Poisonous is annoying too, though, so it's fine. Either way.
I have things you never knew you
wanted. Things you never knew you wanted. You never knew. Bondmaker again, too. I think we still stick to a good old Blade Boy here, but I don't know if this is worth killing or not, but it feels pretty free for only losing one damage, right? And this might get it healed out anyway, so. Oh, I love Park Panther. If this can live to attack, that is nice. All right. Are we actually going to save this run? Like, I still don't actually believe. I still have, like, no faith. But Kilted Gargoyle, Call of the Grave. Wow, that's wild. Coins are really good for priests, so that's pretty nice. Oh, Park Panther, dude. Let's go. Oh, Ace in the Hole. I feel like that can give me some really intriguing options later. Maybe don't need them at the moment, but later I feel like I'm going to be nuts. Oh. Am I replaying Blade here or like developing more stuff?
My blade stays sharp.
I don't know. I can always replay Blade next turn. Doesn't really matter, right? But I guess we'll play it now. I have a question about whether or not I should flurry.
Almost out of time.
I don't think I'll flurry. I don't really care if they get a coin right now that badly. It's okay. I also don't really mind minion trades that much. Man, that's a good minion too. Like, yes, there's some decent trades, of course, but I'm not that stressed about it. Ultimately, I just want to go hard. So, I think saving this for, like, a game break, like a turn where I'm about to win or they're about to kill me is probably a bit more impactful. As Parappa the Rapper once said, you gotta believe, you gotta believe. I remember so vividly the first time I saw that game in the Isles of Target on the PlayStation. I was so perplexed, but also, in, you know, enjoying it and intrigued. Like, it was just something else, I gotta say. They are all in right now. Holy crap. They had a nice secret passage there, though. Hopefully they don't get anything great here. Like, anything that fills their hand back up, because their hand is empty as soon as they come out of the secret passage. It had, like, one card, right? Oh, come on! Why is it always Shadow Word Void? Oh, I'm so sick of this card. Oh, I really hate it. It's always Void, dude. Oh my god. What a chain of stuff, by the way. What an actual just crazy chain of stuff. I don't think I can win now, honestly. I maybe something off of Wand Thief is going to get me there. I don't know. I like need to play this first to combo, right? So hopefully it freezes actual good targets. I guess I could do this, but I only have 3 mana left. That's probably okay. Combustion's still good, right? Like, there's still stuff that answers these at 3. Yeah, sure.
I'm almost out of time. My blade stays sharp.
Hate this so much. I think this is actually a pretty big, pretty important hit here. Nope. I guess that was the better one to get. Oh, that's kind of cool. It's annoying to deal with, maybe. I just can't leave that damage up, right? I'm already down to 25. I don't know. I'm in trouble. Uh, Oh my god. I mean, they are going to take some hits if they use this at least. Like, it's a lot of damage, but I might still be able to race this out depending on how this goes. I feel like I won't really, because these minions kind of suck, but... So in other words, they're kind of getting free hits just to pump this thing up like crazy. Yeah, I don't really know how to get there now. 23 is such a hill to climb, right? We come from far just to see you. I feel like they just hit the nuts this game, honestly. I feel like their rolls were just so perfect. So that's 10, 14. I don't know if I really have a lot of choice here. I think I kind of have to go face. Swindle is so expensive. What can this find me? What's in my ace in the hole? I don't even know. Oh my god. This doesn't even hit anything in their hand, right? I think it's stranded. What does ace in the hole get? What did I play last turn? Bunch of garbage, right? Like, just a bunch of useless stuff, I think. Swindle into what is good? Nothing. Absolutely nothing. Prep for later. Actually, don't want this to hit the Thalnos now, sadly. Good, okay, that's a good one. Oh, Prize Plunder is pretty cool. I don't know about this race, right? I think I'm dead. I think I'm dead, but I what can I do? I save one if I hit the 0-3. That doesn't seem meaningful, right? I think I'd rather give myself outs. I need, I don't know. I only have 7 mana. There's just no way. There's just no way. Yeah, they are hitting minions. They're not killing me this turn. Man, if I could freeze face, I'd have a go of this. Can I get any way to freeze face? I gave up my Wand Thief off the ace in the hole last turn. They're also at 14, though. Can I deal 14? I only need 10.
Be quick.
I need 10. Does not feel like it gives me 10, and I don't think I have any way to freeze, right? I think I'm dead. Do I have any weapon break? No, I can maybe find one or make one. Stealth myself is also a possibility, but I don't see how to do any of that with my current resources. Swashburglar into something insane, like a heal or... a stealth or a boys, make some room by God knows what. Boys, make some room by the hearth, won't ya? Cariel doesn't do it. There's just nothing left, right? I don't have it. Spyglass into something insane. Sinister Strike's not it, so... Yeah. Yeah, GG. Whoa, so many subs all at once. Sinister with 28 months. Oh my god, good to see you, dude. Mitochondrian with a prime sub, and Chips and Coke with a prime sub as well. Amazing. Thank you, everybody, for the subs rolling in on Saturdays, man. That's nice. And wow, 240 of Ilganoth, amazing. This run was like, we almost bailed this run out. This was a surprisingly good treasure combo, I have to say. Like, I think you could play towards this and do some cool stuff. In Rogue, actually, too, I think could be a really good deck for it. We didn't, we played for spells and kind of had to pivot. So to get three out of this was maybe actually miraculous in a way. I think it was one of the worst treasure sets we've ever had. And we still got pretty close, so. Maybe not too bad. All right, so to finish the stream here, I'm actually going to hop back into the Tavern Brawl of all things, not standard, because that's where we're at these days. Because there was two things I really liked about the standard brawl. Being able to force your opponents to play your cards. Like, you build a 15-card deck, your opponent plays your deck, half of their deck is your deck. Means that you can do two things. Force them to play Nosdormu, which that's fun, number one. And number two, oh my god. You could also force them to play Curse Blade. That's not where I was going with this, but that's a fun idea. You can also force them to play a control deck. And I think that's something that I want to do. Actually. I think I want to play like a big control Pirate Warrior. Well, I don't know if I need it to be Pirate Warrior or not. What do you guys think? Is Pirate Warrior worth it? Maybe not. Maybe I just want a control deck, actually. Yeah, I think I actually do really want to play odd control Pirate Warrior. Like, I want to go into wild and do that. But for this, I think I specifically more want... I want to make my opponent play control cards. Maybe I don't even really like Cargo Guard that much because they can attack me with Cargo Guard. I want things that are like specifically just built for armor gain, right? Cards that like force the game to be played slow. Shield Block actually might make my opponents draw too many cards. That may not be good again. They could draw off Heavy Plate, I suppose, but it doesn't seem that good. Drawing off Heavy Plate. Hey, Fabinger dude with 20 months, man. That's amazing. What else is really good for a really defensively like forcing my opponent to play slow and defensively, not giving them cards to attack me with necessarily. A lot of armor gain. I've got my hero power, of course, which is great. What else fits this mold, right? I need help here, guys. Nobody's chiming in. I think shield slams are useless for my opponent, but good for me, so that's nice. Tourney rovers are probably okay. Archivist Elysiana is actually a fun idea, yeah. Sure. Make the game last long in case they have... Man, this is... It can go mana odd, but it's... It's really... Oh, she's 8. Oh, she's 8 now. They unnerfed her. Oh, I forgot. Never mind. Can't do that. We could do Dr. Boom, but that would give my opponent resources and stuff to do. I mean, this is 15 cards. Maybe this is it. I don't really love Cargo Guard, though. I wish I had something that was... Like, that gives them... I don't know. It's not that much attack. It's probably fine. It's too freaking attack. So, yeah, this... Forces my opponent to play a control deck. But is my Baku going to break because of... Did we decide if this breaks or not? Oh, it does. I don't even know. Does this break? Does anybody remember? I can't remember how it worked. We played this the other day, but I don't know. Does Baku even work? Well, let's test it and see. If Baku doesn't work, I'm going to concede and redo this, obviously. Baku triggers before. Okay, so Baku does work. All right, good. So Baku works. We'll have a crazy defensive hero power, and we'll force our opponent to play a control deck. This is exactly what I want. Okay, good. This is what I want from Hearthstone, right? My god, if they won't give it to me in standard, I'm going to take it in Tavern Brawl. You have to play fast because of Nosdormu, and you have to play a control deck. No. Screw you. So hopefully I have enough actual control pieces here to like outpace anything my opponent does that's like more aggressive, right? That'll be the check. Baku works. Baku's doing work. Thanks to the bits, folks. None. Yes, Baku. And Nosdormu, let's go. Perfect. I've concocted the ultimate Hearthstone experience. It's so great. I want this tavern brawl to be a form, like a regular Hearthstone format, right? I want to be able to play slow. Actually, I don't know if that trades any good. Hero Power just kills us now. Slow and steady. Well, fast and slow really is the name of the game here. Fast turns, but slow decks. That's what we want. So we can get our really grindy 30 turn games without actually, I don't know about this. Without actually taking an hour to play the 30 turn games, right? It's perfect. Yeah, I don't know. Maybe I need more early game removal. I certainly don't mind giving my opponents removal. I like it. His deck is kind of, his deck's not really that aggressive, right? Flame Juggler? Really? Just draw a card. I can brawl soon. That's fine. But I need, need a Shield Slam, I think. Every time I've played this, I've really felt like I had more of my opponent's cards than mine. Every time. It's probably just a psychological thing happening, but... Seems like an early brawl, doesn't it? This is scary, though. I need to deal with this. Kind of regret giving that up. I didn't really have a choice, I guess. I think maybe that trade was fine, because I would have killed it anyway, so... Okay, that's better. It's an early brawl, but I know they're not gonna have that many crazy minions, right? It's all like little garbage we can see. So. And my hero power certainly beats theirs, so theoretically, right, there's some equivalence established here. This is such a cool card. The friendly bartender. He should show up in Battlegrounds somehow, I feel like. I don't know how, but he's such a cool looking character. I love Tauren. We don't have enough Tauren in Hearthstone anyway. This guy should 100% show up in Valorant. What's this gonna be? Leaving this up to trade back? Oh, the heal. Wow, big time heal, bro. His fungal enchantries have been clutch. Ugh, I need stuff. I gotta start trading these in. I have plenty of life. I just need stuff. Unhappy with the amount of stuff I've accrued. Battle Fiends are so bad for me. But we're still 34, chilling on board. We'll eventually hit that other brawl. My hand is really weak, though. I need Shield Slam. He's probably got a hand that's like full of Shield Slams though, right? Like stuff he can't use very well. Maybe a Baku in there. That's actually what I need to Shield Slam probably. Oh, he's just not playing. That's a great way to let me back in the game, I have to say. Oh, whoa! I was not expecting him to have that.
Little known secret.
I guess he AFK. I guess he doesn't want to. I guess he doesn't want to play against Odd Warrior. Man. Friendly or little known secret. Friendly bartender, bartender Bob are rival bartenders. That's why they don't appear in each other's format. Well, I can't wait to go to the friendly tavern. Screw bartender Bob. This guy looks like he'd give me way better minions. Yeah, I guess. I think they were playing this deck to sort of like counter, you know, the decks of the meta, but maybe they didn't really counter my deck that much. I thought they were in a good spot though, you know? They weren't, Oh, maybe they're back? Maybe they DC'd. Oh, I thought they were like giving up, but maybe they DC'd. The Nazdormu just caught up to him, I guess. Or not, I don't know. This is also cool that they can't like rope you. Cause it's just always the rope. You know, there's something to that. You can't be roped because there's always a rope. Okay. Well, first game didn't go exactly to plan, but still having a good time. You just can't get BM that hard because of Nas. There's a max BM timer of 15 seconds. Okay. GG. I wasn't expecting the violet worm. That's wild. Put some more early removal. Yeah, I don't actually disagree. I don't either, Shmoodius. Yeah, it's been very common. I don't really know how it's that disruptive. Yeah. I do agree with you about the early removal thing, though. I actually don't really want to give them minions at all. I think I just want early removal. So, like, Coerce, maybe. It's not that good, though. Bladestorm, maybe. Sword and Board. Problem is, right, I only have certain manas here. There's just not that many good options. Shiver their timbers, not that good. Oh, we could go spiked wheel. This is actually pretty good. We know we're going to be able to gain armor. So spiked wheel's good. And it'll be bad for most opponents too, because it's armor based. So that's actually really nuts. That's kind of the perfect option. Oh, maybe we could just double up and do bladed gauntlet as well. That's kind of cool too. Yeah. I think I like those actually. Oh, that's two mana. No, I can't. Shoot. Never mind. Scratch that. Two mana. No can do. Quartermaster gives them too many outs. Could do Reckless Flurry, actually. That's pretty good. It's always going to deal at least four and sometimes more, and it'll be bad for my opponents again. I like that all these armor synergy cards are so bad for my opponents, right? Good for us, but bad for opponents. Maybe just more shield slams. Yeah, this is like... I don't know. I almost feel... This almost feels more evil in a way. Like, I wasn't really planning to make it, like... totally non-existent, like non-functioning for my opponents. I just wanted to play a good, honest control deck. But I guess this is like even more, you know, you must play control. We're playing an attrition fatigue deck no matter what, okay? This is your destiny. If anybody has ignite though, we're gonna be screwed. We're really gonna be messed up if anybody has ignite. That will ruin us. I don't know what to keep. Maybe see what their cards are. Seems like a great hand. Actually, my cards. Nice. I hope they get the same hand. I think the goal here is to get to 100 armor, right? I just want to overwhelm their armor. Trading in makes sense. Oh, okay, it's Hero Power Mage, sure. I'm gonna coin armor. I want as much armor as I can. I don't suspect this deck will have an ignite, right? I mean, if it does, I guess I'm also going to have an ignite. I can still outpace theirs technically, right? Or keep up with it, because my Hero Power will outpace their health. So, if anything they have, I'm also going to have. Now, I mean, obviously Hero Power stuff's going to be better for them than for me, but Ignites, which are the only, like, infinite resource, won't be. And my Hero Power will beat theirs based on normal Wildfire upgrades, right? Because they're only going to get this to 3 normally. And I'm healing for 4 per turn. So I think there's just, like, some inevitability here. They'd have to get some sort of distinct minion advantage over me to, to be able to win this, right? Like, hit me with minions a lot. Because Mordresh isn't going to be enough. I'm already at 42. Kill that. That's fine. I mean, you know, their hero power is like almost keeping up. It's pretty good, frankly. It's not bad. It's just, I think I'll be able to outpace. Because eventually, they're going to have a handful of spiked wheels. I guess I did give them heavy plate so that spiked wheel is useful for them. I didn't realize that. Maybe I need to take the heavy plates out. They're just using it to trade, so they maybe don't anticipate that. I mean, I don't really care if they get 6 damage, I guess. Not the end of the world for me. Yeah, let's play dudes. If you play this enough, you can shift the meta to everyone playing armor synergy. Make Tavern Brawl the control game meta. I don't have that much influence, but boy do I wish I did. That would be really cool. If the entire meta shifted to armor decks. Oh, that would be fun, dude. I would find great pleasure and joy in that. I need actually Shield Slam for this. This is hard to kill. Oh, nice. Okay. This is kind of a freebie. We're at 45. My opponent's hand is going to get worse and worse at the course of the game because it'll naturally filter down to just the stuff they can't use as what's remaining in hand. So it'll just be a hero power race at some level. I'm going to play an 8-8 as well at some point. It's kind of cool. Man, these are hard for me. I'm going to have to face tank this. Kind of a pain. Hey, we did a damage. Wow, we're an aggro deck. Let's go. So many people are going to be so bored by this, but I don't care. I'm having fun. Just deal with it. Any plays for duels today? We just finished like 2.5 hours of duels, man. Sorry. Bad timing. Favorite Mountain Dew flavor? All only Mountain Dew I drink is Diet Mountain Dew. I don't know. I don't know any other Mountain Dew flavors. I used to like Code Red, I guess, back in the day. Long, long time ago. Okay, this is probably one of the better brawls we're gonna get, actually. Hopefully this guy... Well, he'll always die, because I can weapon him at least. Okay. Yeah, he's getting his part of the deck pretty reliably here. I'm impressed. But now he's gotten 2 amplifiers down. I don't know if he has triplicates in his list. He might, right? If he has golden stuff. I guess we've only seen normal ones so far, so maybe not golden ones. But maybe. So he's got a Mordresh that I can't currently kill. That's a big problem, actually. If he plays Mordresh here, I'm not able to kill it. So might want to play my own Mordresh first just to ensure that I can deal with it. Or let's go Nas into hero power this turn. Same difference, I guess. Well, I don't know. His Mordresh will kill this, though. So what's the? There's no point in playing it ahead of time. Like that doesn't Baja make sense. Blast. That doesn't work. I just need Shield Slams. I think I liked Baja Blast fine, but I don't really remember. I feel like I had it at Taco Bell once in my life or something, but I don't know. I feel like my wife bought some kind of diet craziness recently, but I don't remember liking it that much. I'm not the Mountain Dew aficionado people might expect, I guess. Apparently. Alright, this game has definitely devolved into nonsense. Yeah. They're gonna eventually have Shield Slam Heavy Plate action. I'm surprised they don't already, honestly. I really, really need to... Oh, there's my Shield Slam. Okay, so now I need to get enough health to guarantee that I can Shield Slam the Mordresh, right? So after it deals 10, I still need to be able to Shield Slam it, which currently, right, I have like 8, but he could also hero power, so actually, I don't have enough. I need more. He's trading. Finally killed the Nas. Oh, that's actually a lot of healing later. Let's keep that. Timbo this one now. I don't want both up there once against Mordresh, right? I think sticking one at a time is fine, but... This game's ridiculous, dude. Why are people watching this? This is just me, like, savoring my own little corner of the universe and enjoying it so much. I don't know why you guys are here. You're pervs looking in on me here. Okay, so the hero power is getting into a spot where we can answer Mordresh now, because Reckless will also give me 8 armor now if there's a Mordresh on board, right? So I only need to keep 2 into the Mordresh. Oh, plus normal hero power is 12, actually, so I don't even need anything. I can always answer Mordresh with these 2 cards. Baku, though, I also need to kill, huh? Well, shoot. I have more shield slams, but I don't have them yet. Let's see if I can find one, maybe. Okay, I'm gonna play some stuff here. Just to get enough armor to, I don't know, tank a Baku and Mordresh hit, maybe. But I definitely need that other shield slam. I think I have a few left. Maybe? How many did I play? 3 or 4? I don't know. I think I played 4, right? So, we'll see. Reckless Flurry. Oh my god. See, I shouldn't have given them heavy plate. This was a mistake. I think I can just kill this with my weapon attack now, though, since they damaged it. That's nice. That means I have really just one threat remaining, which is Mordresh. And I think I'll have more than enough ways to answer that. And then, of course, I'll be heavily favored in fatigue because I have... Well, not that heavily favored, technically. Their hero power almost keeps up with mine, but I have a much higher health total to start from, so... Should still be a notable advantage. Okay. I'm actually losing a little life here because I'm not really dealing with this. I definitely don't want a Reckless Flurry yet because I'll lose all my armor. This has actually ended up closer than I expected, really. You know, they're like kind of keeping up almost. Kind of have some awkward stuff happening. I'm not really netting enough right now. That'll be fine though. I need them to play Mordresh, actually. I'll feel a lot better once I can commit my stuff. I can actually Reckless Flurry this. This is a fine Reckless Flurry turn. Because like I said, this is enough to answer the Mordresh always. Now Heavy Plate as well seals that deal, so. It's a good opportunity to have a fairly low health total for the Reckless Flurry. So, they've played all my minions. They have literally Mordresh, maybe a Pyromaniac, maybe another Reckless Apprentice. I think that's about all. I mean, good on them right now though for like playing this out. You don't always have to play this out, you know. I think there's some likelihood I'm going to win, but I don't know. Maybe they, I don't know how they'd piece it together. I guess they just have to stick a Mordresh, they think. But if you can get a lifetime supply, oh, speak of the devil, of any kind of snack, what would you pick? I love fresh tomatoes right out of the garden. Just a hot, fresh tomato out of the garden. Homegrown, fresh tomato is my favorite food on earth. So, warm, fresh tomatoes.
Your armor can deal one more damage.
I bet that was not the answer you were expecting, but yes, our armor deals 1 additional damage. It's so OP. Oh, this is some kind of priest. Dragony Priest, okay. They might have, oh, I didn't change my deck to take away the armor that I give them, but it's okay. I like heavy plate enough that it's probably fine. Oh, hey, this is actually a synergy. Let's go. They might have more dragons, so this might be an unnecessary keep is the only thing. I don't know. Let's just be safe with it, though. Twilight Whelp. Okay, well, now I can play the Whelp for tempo at least. Let's go. Survive. This should be fun. They're gonna have some real threats here. Also, they may be able to make enough cards off of a Draconid operative if that's what they're running to give me some pause. Although I may also have one of those, I guess, so I could also make some cool stuff. I wonder if people like playing the Stormy games in Tavern Brawl or not. Is this common? I haven't actually seen a duplicate Nazdormu much, like our opponent was running a Nazdormu, right? So I think I like the idea of people being forced to stress about Naz. It's fun to get people to stretch their legs a little, you know? Regis, you're causing incredible anxiety in people. How dare you? Oh, it's fun. I love it. I love making them anxious. Ooh, that's fun. Okay. What are they planning for that, I wonder? Baku is not a dragon. No, she's like a snake. I think she's based on a Filipino snake god. Which I asked my wife about. My wife is Filipino, but she and her family were not familiar with that. So I guess it's, you know, regional or specific or not that crazy well known. Of course, this is just a Warcraft version of all that, but okay, there is indeed that big boy we were talking about.
Her family did not worship Baku. Missing out.
I don't really want to hit that, right? Because hero power just heals it up. Yeah, no, they're they said no. We don't know who Baku is, but Gin Greymane is very important religious figure to our family. We're an even family here. We hate odd numbers. We only want even numbers in this family. Seems like a pretty good time for Reckless Slurry, right? Just clear enough and don't lose a ton of armor along the way, so. Yeah, see, Kirsten is also Philippines, apparently from the Philippines, and did not know Baku either. But that's what everybody said when it came out. I mean, I had never heard of it, obviously, and then I looked it up, and it's... Here, we can learn more. Baku Nawa is the original name, a serpent-like dragon in Philippine mythology. So there you go. I think we'll just take big minions, right? That seems pretty reasonable. Baku Nawa, serpent-like dragon in Philippine mythology. It's believed to be the cause of eclipses, earthquakes, rains, and wind. Movements of the Baku Nawa served as a geomantic calendar. Geomantic? I don't even know what that word means. Calendar system for ancient Filipinos and were part of the shamanistic rituals of the Babaylan. It is usually depicted with a characteristic looped tail and a single horn on the nose. There's no horn here. It was generally believed to be a sea serpent. Oh, wow. So it sounds like they mostly sort of were inspired by the name and then, of course, you know, took liberties here and there. Cool, we learned though. We learned something. Yeah, oh, this does actually say serpent-like dragon. Yes, yeah, so they took the serpent side of it more than the dragon side of it, I guess. Sea serpent style. Cool. That's a reasonably good shield slam target, yeah. This game has been way more about geomantic. Oh yeah, what did the word geomantic mean? Yeah. Geomantic. Relating to the art of placing or arranging buildings or other sites auspiciously. Or relating to divination from the configuration of a handful of earth or random dots. That is a very specific word. That is a very specific word.
I gotta move.
Okay. Just keep playing big boys here. I mean, I think we've probably gotten through a large portion of their threats. Sadly for me, I don't know if the Shadow Essence is going to have much left by the time I get it. Or was that generated? Did they make that? No, I don't know. Oh, that's sweet. Playing Baku into my 8-8 is amazing. It's really good news, right? I hate losing a hero power, but with the Reckless Flurry's already down, I think it's okay. And no Shield Slam in hand. We have Heavy Plate too to fix any gaps. So let's just keep the tempo rolling. They already used their armor, so they may not be able to deal with this stuff particularly well. They may have another Heavy Plate to use it. Wow, okay. Top decked it. There you go. Shield Slam attack. Oh, Reckless Flurry's good too. But that did clear their minion at least. Still have hesitations about that Heavy Plate, but... I do almost like the honesty of it, like giving my opponent an opportunity to kind of hang in the game, you know? Like, not making my cards totally useless. Something about that feels kind, so that they're not completely helpless with my armor cards. Yeah, they didn't attack. I wonder if, wait, did they use both heavy plates already? Yeah, they may have lost their opportunity to attack ever. Not that it was probably all that important, but... I think we may have done it again, guys. We're very good at forcing people to give up their hopes and dreams, apparently, in this deck. It's not that evil, though, is what's crazy, right? I'm just asking people to play slow Hearthstone and they can't handle it. Like, yeah, you gotta play slow cards, man. No, I refuse to play a control deck. I'd rather concede than play control. I think we've earned these victories, right? I do feel kind of bad, like people are just chilling, have 5 minutes to play a game, hop in a quick tavern brawl. It's like, ah, oh, crap. But that's why the Nostormu's there, right? So it's not like I'm really, you know, this would be evil if it was like a control warrior that, like, you know, I was taking a minute every turn or roping them or something. Obviously that would be evil. But I'm giving them the luxury of a quick game via Nostormu. It's just, you know, manipulating the style of game while still actually retaining a pretty high pace, you know. It's not like they're really losing their entire day to this or anything. Turns are really short. Magni versus I am roping them. Well, sure. Fair. Is Fresh Scent a card I keep? I presume I'm going to get some beasts, right? Why not? Let's keep it. We're going to get a beast eventually. Justifying your evil. Isn't that what all good villains do? You want villains who are they believe in their cause. You don't want villains who are just blatantly, stupidly evil. Sometimes that's good, though. Holding this for this. I don't want to trade it. In case we need it. Emergency stuff. Probably won't, really, but... Bad company. Watch him play Dinomancy. Oh my god! If I don't have to play Dinomancy. Like, I'm not committed to the Dinomancy life, right? He may play it, but I don't have to. Screw you. Okay, yeah, we're getting a lot of beast synergy stuff here. I think we'll be able to catch up fine. Oh, I'm going to be excited to get that. That's a lot of value for me. Although it is kind of scary for him, too, because he might be able to maintain this, like, kind of toe-to-toe on the value line. I'm going to wait, right? I don't think these are worth killing. I think eventually they'll feed into a brawl. They're not actually beating my hero power even with his hero power. I'm still only taking 4, so it's not like I'm losing a lot along the way. Yeah, I think again I'll probably just chill. Maybe I can play this. It's fine. Ooh, Sure. It's pretty good, actually. Disruptive, nice little thing. I don't want to proc his secret because I don't want to give him Eaglehorn bow charges throughout the course of this game. So as much as I can avoid proccing the secret, I definitely will try. He may just hold on to that weapon for a long time, though, because he may not have a natural one. So we may be like forced to at some point. Thankfully, it wasn't spell-based or anything. It might be minion attack-based, though. Oh, my God. Sergeant Sally clears the board. That's actually hilarious. Terrible result, usually, but kind of perfect, actually, there. Okay. Yeah, I'm kind of full on hand, right? I might have to play a heavy plate soon just to find a way to dump a card or something. Okay, that might be a good shield slam target, honestly, or maybe an attack target if I want to hold some armor. Well, no, I don't know. I'm down on armor anyway. Okay, so he uses weapons, so now we can more freely test, Oh, I forgot. Oh, no, that's fine, that's fine. We didn't care about the secret now, because his weapon's gone. It is kind of annoying, though, actually. I don't want to Reckless Flurry this yet, but it'll again play pretty nicely towards a brawl. Okay. Just using that so I don't burn a card, right? I don't really want to yet, but these are good brawl feeders again. One will get buffed, maybe. Hopefully he plays like two more minions and I can just get a good brawl out of it. Heavy plate. Sure. Commit some minions, man. This isn't a terrible Reckless Flurry either, right? I'm pretty low, so I don't lose much. Maybe we'll take the Reckless here. Kind of want to dump a card anyway, so... I actually like saving coin, weirdly, because I can play Baku Coin Hero Power, which I haven't been able to do in the past. You like to hero power every turn, right? So, all right, so we're still at 30. We've gotten through a portion of his deck already. Feels like a pretty good shield slam target to me. I love this, dude. This is so antithetical to what so many people want out of Hearthstone. I know, like, a lot of people really like fast games. They like really synergistic combos and stuff. I just want to bleed opponents out of resources and out of hope. If they have any hope left, I'm not into it. I want them to feel hopeless. Oh, I'm such an idiot. Oh, God. I'm going to explain to you what happened with the coin just now. I was thinking, oh, I better test pressure plate. Which, number one, doesn't work because there's no minion on board. And number two, I obviously wasted the coin. So in either case, I did not successfully test pressure plate. I can tell you. That was a bit of a whiff. It's like all coined to get rid of the pressure plate, but it doesn't go off if there's no minion. So that doesn't help. Cat trick obviously didn't make a difference. I just missed four armor. Oh my God, Dire Frenzy. That's not good because this game can go on for a long time now. Oh, shoot. I need to make sure I get a better Dire Frenzy target than him. Okay. Yeah, let's wait. We may want to proc that secret in, like, into a, like, snake trap into a brawl or something, right? Whatever. Oh, crap. That's a good marked shot card. Holy crap. I'm actually going to lose this game, dude. And you know what? More power to my opponent for it. Like, what a god. He deserves it. He deserves it if he wins, honestly. Like... It's a cool deck, dude. He's playing a really fun, cool deck. I really respect it a lot. It was awesome. Hopefully he starts running out of gas a little bit because, you know, he's got like a bunch of my garbage in there. I want to hit, like, Huffer Dire Frenzy, right? That's my plan. Oh, he's going to Shield Slam the 1-1. Interesting choice when you know I have the Nozdormu in there. Man, I'm actually feeling the pressure a little bit on the time right now. I'm being honest. I'm feeling a little bit of time pressures, guys.
Cool deck. Are they
I'm like feeling
fun?
The heat a little. Shoot.
This is a game?
Ah, crap. I'm like actually feeling like I ran out of time. Yeah, what is this? You're not supposed to have fun in Hearthstone. What are you thinking? You madman. Okay. This really is an easy answer to this, right? It's one health. Could have used this instead of hero powering. I don't know if it's right or not. Maybe it is. I am really feeling the pressure, man. He's like going face enough that it's making me nervous. I feel like I need that other heavy plate to like stabilize here a little bit. We might need to trade? I don't know. That ram is pretty cool for me. If it dies now, so I... Oh, he is going to kill it now. Okay. Oh, but he's doing his own ram now. That's smart. I can fresh synth the ram, though, right? So... Oh, he killed it. Scratch that. I can't do anything with it. I take it back. I like really don't have great turns. I'm like a little stressed here, dude. I am a little stressed. Hey, Pyro, dude, with 5 gifted subs, man. Thank you. Congrats to Lil Robitussin. What a funny name. Gothic Man, Spurgs, Riggity Raw, and Dirtanger. Oh, this is more damage because of the stupid heavy plate. Oh, I really need a heavy plate because I'm getting nervous, dude. I need to flip this game back. I can finally, like, kind of play a Hunter's Pack, right? I have... Oh, heavy plate. Thank God. I think this gives me so much, like, time luxury now. That's so handy. Oh, whoa. I gotta trigger a rat trap? No. Okay. All right, that gave me a bit more time and window here. That's pretty good. Okay, still though, man, this game is like, I'm really, really feeling, this is the first time I felt the Nozdormu pressure because I have a lot of resources in hand, so I have actual difficult decisions to make, right? Okay, that was a bit of a slow turn for him, thankfully. That's really, really good news for me. There's probably some decent beasts in here, right? Oh yeah, that's fine. Go ahead and do this just to kind of empty the hand a little bit. I need to start dumping stuff so that, I actually have what's his name here? Waxadred. So that's 2 Waxadreds in my deck right now, which is pretty sweet. Okay, yeah. Finally stabilized, I think. We're back to 24 health. Pretty good turns. I got some actual crazy stuff in hand. Halazi's like a nice reload, and Serpent Bloom can clear his thing, right? So, finally feeling a little stable here. And now my hero power will start gaining over theirs, which is nice. They're hitting minions, which is nice. Okay. Feeling safe for the first time in quite a few turns. All right. Also, I mean, their hand size is just diminishing, right? So they may be running out of gas a little bit. Hopefully they don't have, like, another Hunter's Pack. I need to hit these Waxadreds soon, though, man. Okay. That's fine. He's going face on this one. Interesting. That must be an explosive trap, then. Which I unfortunately can't use Fresh Scent on this. Which is fine. We'll just kill it. It's okay. Oh, it's not. It's Wandering Monster. Okay. Oh, that's fine, too. Okay. get some of these in hand while also still keeping space for my top deck. I am actually behind in fatigue, for the record, because I have two Waxadreds in my deck. That said, I haven't yet hit the Dire Frenzy that we know he has. So I will start to catch up on fatigue once I get that Dire Frenzy, as long as I don't burn it, which currently we're okay with. His armor's gone. Okay, sweet. Starting to stabilize, team. He's out of armor, right? Because I think he used both heavy plates. Yep. So no more armor synergy cards, which I think he already used them all. Shield Slam, Spiked Wheels. He might have one Shield Slam left that he can't use, which is nice. All right. Did we do it? This was actually a really good game. This was the coolest Tavern Ball game we've had yet, I think. Particularly with this deck. Whoa. Those are big, but we're okay. Serpent Bloom handles that just fine. Okay. Sure. We got one of those too. Also a good Shield Slam target. All right, this might have done it here. We might have just locked this up. That might have been the turn of the corner there. And I still have two Waxadreds in my... Or is it three? I have three now Waxadreds in my deck. Half my deck is Waxadreds. So that's definitely going to get me there once I hit the Waxadreds. He's not gonna have an answer to those. I think we're good anyway. Rock Dollar's also just 8 more damage, so. And back to 27 life. So Hero Power here is definitely farming. This has been cool. It's another good Shield Slam. We'll just hit face, Rock Dollar, and win next turn, right? Well, I hit a Waxadred. I did, finally. Oh my god. Didn't think it was possible there for a minute. Oh! Rock Dollar's active! What?! Rockdelar's actually active! How is that possible, dude? No, I don't have the lethal, though. No lethal, sadly. I can't believe it! That's cool. Oh, wow. Full hand of awesome spells now. We're gonna burn the Dire Frenzy, but I think we're okay. Got a lot of Waxadreds coming in. Oh, he actually had another tradable armor up guy. I thought we used those. I think we're fine. I actually don't have lethal again, though, and I'm going to burn some cards. This is not lethal, right? No? I mean, I have a pretty crazy petting zoo, though. Not a bad turn. 4 3-3s. It's cool. I've actually made his deck almost work better than I think... that I think he has, just because we got some lucky rolls, right? It's fun. Hey, holy moly, another 14 gifted subs from Pyro. Let me read through those once this game is over here in a sec. All right, steady shot. Of course, Leok? No, Misha, sad. And there's that last heavy plate. Get us back to over 30. Cool. Really fun game, dude. That was exactly what I wanted out of this deck. That was awesome. Pyro! Grats to Dr. Eyepatch, Quicker Cash, Captain Hindsight, Baron of Fate, The Game, Dukes, Angus, Odin Hansen, Mr. Morden, Fyramus, Lich King Ner'zhul, Rainfire, Bicknell, and Shadow Wanathan. Wow. Unbelievable. 14 gifted subs. Good to see you as always, Pyro. Thanks for the kindnesses, man. Grats, everybody. That's 1,900 total subs. Can you guys believe that garbage? 1,900 total subs. What a madman. That's the craziest thing I've ever seen, dude. Thank you, Pyro, for the 1,900 subs. An actual legend. Guys, that was a 15-minute game, even with Nazdormu. Jeez. Actually crazy. Ooh. Ooh, Warpress Purifier is so fun. Okay. Thankfully, I didn't give them like a lot of neutral cards. I love this idea, though, because everybody's playing these like synergistic cards. Well, that doesn't really... I don't know. That doesn't really change their cards, though, because the class cards are the ones they need. So never mind. I don't know what this is all about. But anyway, it's fun for me. I'll take it. Okay, it actually makes my Baku and my Nazdormu a little better, arguably, right? Because I get... That's like the only neutral cards in my list, right? It's Baku and Nazdormu. Oh, I don't want to play Sir Finley, though. My Hero Power is sick. I don't want that. One of the guys who just got gifted a sub is playing it now. For real? Oh my god, it's Wanathan. Yeah, you're right. And Shadow Wanathan just got gifted a sub. Wow. Actually crazy. Okay. Oh my god, we got Malkazar in here too. I love this guy's memery right now. I can't play this though. Until I like need a lethal anyway. That's crazy. Alright. We'll hero power still. I know it's boring, but it's the way of the Odd Warrior. It's just mandatory. You have to. Maestra. I thought you guys said she was banned. Or no, that was duels. Is she not banned in this? Wait, is my opponent not actually a warlock? Are they a rogue? Are they a rogue? That's what this means, right? Cause, yeah, oh my god. Shenaniganery's afoot. Clean up this mess. I sense shenaniganery. Wanathan. He's in chat and he's memeing on us. Oh boy. Oh boy. Wayne? This is not Taylor. Okay, that's not so bad. I mean, we don't know what the other cards are anyway, right? So we might as well play that. Maybe this fills in the curve better. I know a guy? Sure. Dirty Rat seems fun. Shadow Wanathan, shame on you. Malkazar. Maybe this was just from the Malkazar. Oh, that's another explanation, right? I did proc my Malkazar. Oh, I forgot about Malkazar. Maybe he's not actually a rogue. I don't know if we'll ever know. We may never know. How can we tell? It might just be Malkazar, right? Malkazar could give me a Maestra. If the other deck had Maestra, would it proc for me as well? I don't know how it works. Malkazar cannot give cards from other classes? Are you sure? Is that real? Why? Feels like he should be able to.
You can't always trust what you see.
Okay, why was she a wisp at first? Did you guys, or not a wisp, a tiny fin? Did you guys see that? Has that always done that? That was a tiny fin. I'm not crazy. I'm pretty sure I saw a tiny fin when I played Maestro, right? It does it every time. Oh, okay. That is very strange. I can't imagine why, but Hearthstone be Hearthstoning. Sure. The grizzled wizard here. Was he going to try to steal my hero power? I think he was, right? He was going to steal my hero power and I just ruined it with Dirty Rat, I think.
He never gives duplicate legendaries that you already have or legendaries from other classes.
He never gives duplicate legendaries that you already have or legendaries from other classes. Is that true? I feel like I've gotten legendaries from other classes with Malkazar before. But I certainly don't remember well enough to say for sure. What happens if this gets traded? Does it still get destroyed or does it live? Oh my god. Okay, shenanigans are very much afoot. It still gets destroyed! What? We learned something today. It still gets destroyed. That is actually wild. I am glad we learned that. Well worth the test, I would say. I want to read about Malkazar because I just like almost can't believe that. I don't unbelieve it. It seems so strange. Like he follows discover rules almost.
cards doesn't count as playing them and doesn't remove
them. It says right here, yeah, in the wiki. Only cards suitable for the player's class will be chosen. Abiding by regular deck building rules. Yeah, it says it right here. That's wild, dude. I didn't know that. So that means that definitely this is a rogue with Tess. But they're only gonna get a bunch of random garbage warrior cards, right? In other words, they're gonna get like wait, how did he get a Shadow Council? I don't even know where that came from. But they're only gonna get, you know, brawls and all this other garbage stuff. A little better here, huh? My Tess, though, is totally stranded. I mean, I can't do anything with Tess, right? Well, I got Rogue. Well, does she replay herself? Once I play her and bounce her, she'll replay herself and the Maestra, I guess, right? I think. Well, let's just do that now. Get a free Maestra and bounce Tess. So now I get 2 6-6s. I don't know if this is worth it. Just for 2 6-6s and a 3-2. That's not that good.
She will not replay herself. She will just summon a copy of herself.
Well, yeah, you know what I mean. I don't mean two battle cries. I just mean like, will she summon herself? Yeah, that's what I mean. We know battle cries don't come off Tess, but it's not like some infinite loop or anything, or even a one-time loop. Brawl's good. Hero power should be fine after. Wait one more turn for Tess. That's a fine result, really. My hero power beats that guy infinitely, right? That's fine. Oh, this is fun. I didn't see this. Yeah, the Worm Rest Purifier definitely made this game more fun. Oh, here's the Tess. Okay. So what did they play? They played Reckless Flurry and the Weapon. Oh, they did get a Demon Hunter card in there. Yeah. And the Guidance. I don't know where half this stuff came from. We were talking about stuff. I didn't even watch. Like, where did these Shadow Councils come from? I honestly don't even know. Cleave. This has a couple of good targets, actually. Is it time for my Tess just to compete with their Tess? Yeah, I guess. It's not going to get better, probably, right? I'm assuming they only have the two rogue cards, so can at least kind of contest the board here. Oh, it's all from Wormrest Purifier. Oh, they finally played the Wormrest. That's where they got the Warlock cards. I'm surprised they went this early on Tess then. Seemed like there might have been more opportunity for that, right? Because you're going to get a lot more Wormrest cards. And they didn't bounce Tess either, so it seems like their win condition's kind of stranded out there. This is an awkward turn for me. Cleave can at least give that rush. That's a little better. We'll just button as always. I am kind of running out of gas here. Yeah, they're definitely going for play as Maestra. Then you're whatever class, right? You're Warlock. You play Wormrest Purifier. You transform all your cards into Warlock cards, all your neutral cards. Then you still have Tess, so that you can use Tess to like replay. But you know, you also transform your Youthful Brewmaster and stuff. So if you don't have a good Brewmaster option, then man, if this hits that, I'm in a little bit of a pickle. Never mind, I'm not in a pickle. We'll just wait on this now. These are fine. Okay, we're out of gas, but we're hanging in there. Alright. Taking 5. This is okay-ish. Wonder if there's ever a world where I'm better off, oh my god. Oh my god, I actually had the weapon upgraded. Oh, that's so sick. I didn't even realize. Oh, wow. Actually, nuts. So, I mean, we're mostly facing off against a bunch of random Warlock cards, right? I mean, they can't be that good on average. We should be fine. You need to be a rogue when you play it because it activates before you swap classes. Wait, what do you mean the Worm Rest Purifier? Why would you want to be a rogue when you play it? You'd still want to be a warlock when you play it. Otherwise, you're just going to get rogue cards. You want the warlock cards, I think, for the test, right? Oh, the test. Oh, yes. Yeah, you need to play Maestra pre-test. Yeah. I see what you're saying. Oh, the test. Yeah. Otherwise, Tess is just going to play rogue cards. You have to swap back over to make yourself not a warlock. I know what you mean. Thought you were talking about Worm Rest. Yeah, we'll trade that in. We got plenty of armor right now. Bumper car. Sure, why not? Feel like we're trending towards inevitability again, right? Our hero power should be able to keep us in this. Enough for our cards and fatigue to win out, hopefully. We still have the brawl for any sort of emergencies. It seems like they're getting down to the point where it's like a bunch of warrior cards. I don't know what's left up there for them, but... Ooh, fun. That equip, baby. The Ogre War Maul. And the art on this is crazy. It almost looks like a render from the game or something. It's weird. It's kind of, I don't know. It just looks like textured over a model or something. It's kind of strange. Who knows, really, but. Okay. Heavy plates, sure. Anchorman's good. I can't move. Very much trending towards lethals here. What's in hand, dude? This is the 15 card brawl, yeah. We're forcing our opponents to play control decks. I only have 9 damage. Should I play Finley for lethal? I called that like early in the game. Like, I won't play Finley until it's lethal. Let's see what we get off heavy plate first. Yeah, still not a lethal. Okay, we'll play Finley for lethal, baby. What do I actually get? Druid or... Yeah, Druid or Mage is fine. Or whatever. Cool. I called this. That's so funny. I called that in, like, turn one. Oh, shoot. That's fun. Okay, GG, man. Yeah, that's right. This is my grind them into despair and hopelessness deck. Yeah. Shadow one of the dude. GG, man. Where are you? I don't know where you went. You went away. That was a fun game for sure. All right, I'm going to play one more, guys, and then I'll hop off. I got to go after this. We definitely got some cool games for YouTube for this one, which was actually my goal. I'm going to put this video up tonight. The AMA videos always do so bad in the morning on Saturdays that I like to get a second video out on Saturday. These AMA videos, just nobody cares. Nobody cares about Hearthstone news, usually. To be honest, I don't blame them. The AMA, like, the questions and the answers are just not as juicy after a while, you know? We get diminishing returns on the XR AMAs. Just, you know, everything's already answered or talked about at some point. So there's just not much left to discuss. Okay, mage again. Let's see if we can beat this mage. This was actually harder than I expected last time. Oh, this is a very intriguing mage, though. This is like a fire mage. They might actually have the ignites we talked about that were a problem. This is definitely looks more like a sort of fiery mage. We saw Hot Streak and Flame Ward now. They might just have ignite shenanigans. You screwed up the test? Oh, you mean you went too early on test? We did talk about that, or do you mean you were hoping to get a youthful first or something, or what? Curious. What you think you screwed up? I'm intrigued. Aku's not good. Either way, GG Shadow wanted to do. That was a really fun game, man. I'll see if that one can go on YouTube. I don't know. It was a little long and kind of just dead at the end. I like that I called my shot for lethal and stuff. That was fun, but we'll see. I can't promise. If there were new controversial topics or fresh content, I would watch the AMAs more. Yeah, no, that's totally fair. I'm not criticizing anybody. I'm agreeing it's diminishing returns in the AMAs. It's the juiciness of the tidbits decrease over time, for sure. Okay. And it's getting kind of weird. I mean, I'm assuming they're not going to have a ton of minions for me to interact with on this stuff. So we're both just going to sit here in hero power all day, which I love. That's great. Sign me up, baby. That's what I want. Let's do it. I will beat their hero power if that's all we do. So please, I want to join this party. Hero power, hero power, hero power, hero power. We're gonna start burning cards eventually, I guess. I can throw away wildfires and stuff, I suppose. Oh, fireball! Interesting! Is there any reason not to send it face? I think I will. Just spend my mana, right? If there are minions coming down, I'll have plenty of ways to interact with them, so I shouldn't need fireballs for like face or for minion clears. So just getting them for face damage while we have mana and hand space and stuff restrictions in mind are good. Oh boy, getting stuck here a little bit. Gonna go ahead and attack with this so that I don't waste value. If I happen to draw another one and want to play it as my hand gets filled up, right? I can then dump the attack and maintain full value, which is nice. They're just throwing away coin. Okay. Oh, there's the ignites. That's what we talked about, right? I want to put mine in first, so I'll pass the Baku turn here. Yeah, so this is like an ignite race almost. I mean, I have a huge lead. That's great. I'm just as likely to find my ignites as far as we can tell now. I mean, they don't seem to have a ton of card draw coming or anything. So I wonder if I'm actually better off just not playing Baku. Their hand is obviously minion based and they seem to be having trouble playing cards. So if I just prevent them from doing that by targeting my minions, maybe I just win. I mean, we'll have to make a consideration when we get to the point where I'm gonna burn a card. But for now, armor up seems way more valuable. This is the dream, guys. We're living the peak Hearthstone experience. All we do is armor. Okay, I need a hot streak, actually. That would be a great card to dump, wouldn't it? Yeah. Oh, I cannot play Reckless Flurry, so it's time to play Baku. I'm going to go ahead and shield slam it as well. You might be thinking that's total insanity, but I just need the hand space more than I need the minion on board, because they're going to clear the minion anyway. And in fact, by not having a minion, it may make it harder for them to play their cards, which may mean, look at this. Same exact story here. I love it. That's so funny. So they left a minion up, so I can actually dump cards on this now. I'm better off dumping shield slams or combustions or some combination thereof. I don't know. I guess combustion and shield slam is the way to go. What a world we've gotten ourselves into here. We're both just making the worst plays possible. Oh, jeez. I have a hand size advantage for sure right now, though. Soak in the peak Hearthstone. See, they can dump the Reckless Flurries, though, without downside, which is an advantage for them. So that kind of sucks. Oh, Fire Sail I can dump. That's great. Could trade it, but I think that's less upside, actually, than just dumping it. I need Nazdormu so I can dump this other Shield Slam. I need to find that other Ignite to just keep the damage rolling. If I get a weapon, of course, I can go face. Another Fireball would be nice. Heavy plate, we can play. That's cool. I'm at 68. It's going to take quite a few ignites to get there, and I surely will be able to kill them by then, because I'll have my own ignites at basically the same pace. More or less, right? First flame's a bad draw, dude. I'm at 70. Time runs out on me. I'm kind of getting stuck here, though, man. Gonna get handlocked if I'm not careful. I need them to play like Nazdormu. Or I can play my own Nazdormu, that's fine. Hot streak's fine. Need that other ignite, man. It's gotta be in there. Surely they're running two, right? So it must have like 2 out of 11 ignites in deck. Okay, what's this play menu, bro? Spiked wheel again. Okay, sure. I would love to get my other spiked wheel. Brawl, uh-oh.
I cannot do that. I cannot do that.
I have a dilemma here about these Reckless Flurries. Like, I could have played one like 5 turns ago and just started armoring up again afterwards. I think I'd rather burn cards. But it's not worth it if I burn the ignites, because I'll lose in fatigue. So I don't know. I have a debate here to make. If I need to burn a Reckless Flurry or not. Hopefully I get a playable card. Oh, God. I have to. It's so miserable, but I have to. I have to get the ignites. If the ignites burn, I'm going to lose in fatigue, maybe. Because I don't think I have enough damage to beat them otherwise, and they're not going to take fatigue damage because they have ignites. Oh, that really hurts. What a terrible draw sequence, right? There's still other cards I could have drawn here, like a Wildfire, a Spiked Wheel, a Nazdormu. There's so many things. Oh, there's a Naz. Okay. They got me to burn my armor, so they're like, yeah, sure, I'll drop the Naz now. They're going to kill it, though, it looks like. Oh, maybe not. They don't have enough mana left. Okay, so that's a way for me to get rid of a card. That's nice. Let's dump the other Reckless Flurry here, right? Oh, I wish I had less armor, though. I can't use First Flame because that doesn't really do it. Okay. We're back. Do-do-do. Oh, I could have played both Reckless, actually. I was thinking you weren't allowed to, but are you allowed to? Are you allowed to? I don't know. How would I say that? No, I want to dump the Reckless. I don't want to dump a Tardy card because I want to dump the Reckless's ASAP because I need to start buttoning again. I think we're going to get to a point where I'm, like, guaranteed to have playable cards soon, right? We drew most of the unplayable ones in a row. Like, I'm gonna get to a point where I have plenty of options here. Because it's just like, we're, you know, I know there's like probably 2 ignites, a Nazdormu, a spiked wheel. It's like, I know I'm gonna have room. You know what I mean? Yeah, but I want to start gaining the armor, too. Oh, you're saying, like, afterwards, maybe? Oh, yeah, that actually may be right. Yeah, you might be right. God, we're already back to 19. Where is this dude's ignite, though? This is wild. Did he only run the one ignite? Like, is that... There it is, finally got the ignite. That's bad, though. I don't want him to have it yet. I don't have that much of a lead right now. You might still run into hand size problems, though. Oh, there we go, baby. There we go, baby. There we go. Now the race is on. That's amazing. What does he have left that he can play out, I wonder? I don't know. Maybe nothing. Maybe he burns his ignite. Heavy plate's a good card to play out for sure.
But yeah, you should have played double too. Reckless. You are allowed to play it without any armor. Your opponent did it.
Ooh, fireballing. Yes. Let's go. We're getting dense now. He's down to 3 cards, though, so he's going to have ignites every turn. I mean, he's only going to have 1 per turn, though, so surely my armor gain will still outpace by the time I get 1 per turn. Because I have a huge advantage. I should have attacked here, actually, to deny his weapon attack. That was a mistake, because that's his last weapon charge. I could have, I think, killed his... There might be one more heavy blade, though. I'm not totally sure. Gonna go ahead and use mine. Should have done it last turn. Ooh, he burned a flame ward, not an ignite! No! Shoot! Ah! That's the other fireball, I guess. Yeah, okay. Ignites. Are there two or one? Oh, there we go, baby. There we go, baby. So that's 5 and 6 on my ignites now. Okay, so that's his ignites. He's getting ignite every turn. I am not getting ignite every turn, unfortunately, but I also have another spiked wheel, I know. And, oh wait, he had the ignite in hand? Wait, oh yeah, okay. He has armor gain too. Oh shoot, this is still close, guys. I don't think this is guaranteed as I'd hoped. All right, we can use this to actually grab the ignite. Now. I mean, I'm netting a lot of armor per turn, so I think we'll still be fine, but it's closer than I would like. Because he's still got 3, too. Like, he's netting every turn as well. Jeez. This game's close, dude. I wish I'd ripped those Reckless Flurries earlier, right? Like, I could have ripped them, like, 3 or 4 turns earlier. I thought we'd be able to keep up with dumping cards, but we just didn't, so. I ended up using more... This is Spiked Wheel, probably. Yeah, we're gonna get screwed. That slows me down a fair bit, because it's not lethal with Ignite now, right? Ignite is 6 and 3. So, I think we're still okay, though. He's got 37 to go. Like, that's only dealing, what, 8 or something this turn? Yeah, we'll be fine. So he's got 9 next turn. So, yeah, I'm totally cool. It's closer than I'd like, but still totally fine. This fire sale's been hilarious, by the way. Screw you, fire sale. Don't even really need to attack, but no harm. Wow, cool, crazy, weird game, dude. Very strangely required path in this game. Very weird.
He got through your armor. Very strange.
He did get through the armor, yeah. Indeed. I don't think this game go on YouTube. It's just like too slow. Like, it's a cool win condition, yes, but it's just so slow. I finished at 28, so he did do 2 damage to me this game. He did all this work for 2 damage. That's kind of sad, dude. Oh, he put in like 20 minutes for 2 damage. Oh boy. Okay, guys, I gotta go. I'm gonna hop off. Thanks to the bits, Brimstone. Yeah, happy to raid. I'm glad it went well, apparently. Let's call it there. I will see you guys. I think I'm gonna stream tomorrow, but I think I'm gonna do some variety stuff tomorrow. There's a bunch of demos that hit Steam I want to play and test out and have fun with. So stay tuned to Discord. I'll probably stream over on my side channel on YouTube as opposed to here on Twitch. So you might need a link from Discord or whatever. Here, I can also just link you to the channel here right now. Here's my side channel. I think that's my plan for tomorrow. There's your link to that channel. Go check it out for my variety stuff. And we'll do that tomorrow probably. And then back to the regular scheduled stuff on Monday for Hearthstone. But let me drop a raid. Let me drop a raid. All right, have fun on the raid, everyone. Thanks for hanging out today. Much love for all the crazy gifted subs and follows and bits and all that stuff. As always, really appreciate everybody chipping in always. That's so nice. Keep an eye out on YouTube for like this deck shenanigans and lots of duels runs. I think I got like 3 duels runs queued up for YouTube now, so lots of stuff coming. Love you all. Thanks for watching. Enjoy the raid, and until next time, game on.